The year was 1994, and people were still getting used to the new Knuckles, the Echidna. He was the brand new friend of Sonic the Hedgehog. Was he a friend or a foe? We didn't know. He was a tough guy, really good with his fists. Really strong guy, he could climb walls. But he ended up to be a good friend in the end. And now we all love him. Actually, the first thing he did after stealing your emeralds was in fact chuckle. He had a very big chuckle at your expense. Alright, let's go ahead and get started here. And to get my playlist going. This one's actually 1993. Whoa, spoilers, please. Alright, so we got a whole bunch of stuff lined up for you between commercials, promotional tapes, trade show videos. I think we'll get to the Pokemon stuff this time. I don't think we got to do that last time. And, quite a bit. So this is a promo for the Sega Channel from 1993. I will have to check audio on this.
Wow! Welcome to the newest thing on television, Sega Channel. It's available now.
This one's a little blurrier, so I apologize.
It's the first interactive network,
but
providing
you know how it is for
on demand 24 hours a day.
Stuff this old.
With Sega Channel, you play what you want, when you want, for as long as you want, for one low monthly price. Hi, I'm Eric Hastings, here to show you how to
stop
Sega just
Channel.
Watching TV and start playing it on Sega Channel. Now, you've heard about interactive
It's digital
TV
distribution.
Before. Well, this is the real thing.
Oh, there's
Sega
Knuckles.
Channel gives you video games on demand up to 50 different games.
do not call this number.
Great games all right at your fingertip.
There's no way I could play all these games if it wasn't for Sega Channel.
That's right. Thank you, Sega Channel.
And it keeps my kids at home.
There are more games than I've ever seen on Sega Channel.
Test drive.
Sega Channel keeps my kids off the streets.
Just been released or soon to be released. These games are so new, it's like looking into the future.
I like test drives because I can check out hot new games.
I will say that
playing up to 50 different video games a month for one low monthly price.
And this
Sega
was
Channel,
pretty ahead of its time for the time.
With a video game right at your fingertips.
It's very economical, especially with a household of kids.
I do anything.
I don't think this is Australian because there are no Australian accents.
Convenient. With Sega
Maybe
Channel,
I don't know.
You're right in your own home. Parents, you can order Sega Channel anytime by simply calling the number at the bottom of your screen. Oh, but right now we are going to take you to video game paradise.
Oh yeah! This is the ultimate Sega.
Oh God, that's right. They got the dude from Nick Arcade to promote this.
Hi, I'm Phil Moore. Imagine living here, playing what you want, when you want.
Oh, look at all those angular squares. I love it.
Sound great? Well, guess what? You can live it right in your own home. With Sega Channel, you get up to 50 different video games per month for one low monthly price. That's about $2,500 worth of video games. You know how many lawns you got to mow to get that? A whole bunch. But no, you get them 24 hours a day with Sega Channel.
I love that mowing lawns is like the only amount of work kids can process. Like, how many lawns is that? How many lawns to a dollar?
Sega Channel.
I've always got something to do with my friends now that I've got Sega Channel.
Sega Channel is something we can
oh
do
God,
with the kids.
It's, I mean, it's hard to tell, but you can see the little Sega Channel dude in the corner having a time.
There's no question about the value, variety, and convenience of Sega Channel. As a mom, what I really like is Sega Channel's parental lockout feature. The video game rating system is
that's right.
And easy to understand.
Just adults only, like there were maybe
the
two games released with that coding in North America.
I want control over what my kids are playing. And with Sega Channel, I have it.
Now I don't have to watch my kids.
I know where they are.
Setting up to play is easy with Sega Channel. Here's how it works.
There were very few adults-only games in general.
Plug it into the Sega Genesis. Turn on the Sega Genesis and the TV. Up comes the Sega Channel screen. And then you get a menu of the game category.
Menu, tell me more.
Pick your category.
God, this looks so awkward. She's holding the Genesis and controller while trying to do all this and narrate.
It downloads.
It's easy.
And bingo, you've got it. Just in case you've got any questions, you can call up full instructions for every game on Sega Channel.
They extremely cut out the downloading screen, by the way. As long as I want.
All right, and there's even more features that can make anyone a great gamer.
Yeah, these are extremely 90s beats.
One of the neatest things about Sega Channel is the game help screen. There's one for each game. You get game description, controller.
Genesis Dennis's with Nintendo Dennis's.
Different levels. Ooh, my favorite. Hints and tips, or you can browse the help files.
Come here. Here's this little.
Oh, what's up, Fillmore?
Sega Channel. I just found out that you get codes, tips,
what?
Video news, special contests.
Oh, why'd you start screaming at me? Fillmore, calm down.
Call your cable company. I'm not gonna bring it to you like the pizza guy. You got to call the cable.
You're screaming
company.
At me, Fillmore. Please stop.
Value, variety, and convenience, and most of all, it's available now. Oops. Sega Channel, the first interactive network.
I have the cursor captured just in case I need to point things out, so I apologize if the mouse pops on screen.
50 different games a month, 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, 365 days a year for one low monthly price. Parents, we've made it so easy. All you have to do is call the number on the bottom of your screen to order Sega Channel. Because
again, do not call this number. Do not call this number right now. A, it would work, you need an area code, and B, probably gonna get a sex line. Oh god.
Just watching TV and start playing. Welcome to Sega Channel. The only channel where you actually play video games. Sega Channel comes 24 hours.
Play video games.
Sega action into your home.
Oh, I think I might have that video. I'm gonna scare you on this playlist. It's one of the ones with the long hair dude. He showed up in a lot of the Sega promo videos.
Knuckles. A special version of Super Street Fighter 2 and more. You get tips on secret moves.
This was actually the only way to get Mega Man, like the Sega port of Mega Man. I don't think they ever actually released it in North America on cartridge. Of course, that emulation happened, and now we can play it whenever we want. First thing that comes up is tire pressure. Alright, call that number if you want to get your tires pumped, I guess. Alright, this one is a little bit smaller, so I gotta trim this down. Alright, this one has a bunch of black space at the beginning anyways. Is it in widescreen? Wait, why can't I crop this now? OBS, please. Let me crop this. OBS, why don't you... Okay, let me try preset transform. There we go. I might have to play around with this now and then because some of these are going to have different aspect ratios. Not rated for little boys. Man, Turbo Duo.
The most exciting news.
It wasn't like a bad console. It just didn't take off.
Technology, until now. Two words describe a phenomenon.
Yeah, Johnny Turbo was the magazine stuff, right? I don't think there are any videos.
Turbo Duo power. With four times the memory of 1 megabit.
Oh man, look at that background.
Power to the next level of excitement. Deeper, more compelling games.
This, I don't think this is actually at 60 FPS.
Larger characters, more realistic animation, faster action, superior scrolling, deadlier bosses, scarier.
Or it could have just been the VHS was recorded at 60 frames, but the actual video is at 30.
With Turbo Duo, you can play standard turbo chip and 1 megabit CDs as well as super CD games.
I love everyone being obsessed with how many bits were in a console. Like, oh man, 2 megabits.
A turbo chip game, 5 separate games at a value of $250, and you won't believe what's included. Ease 1 and 2, the sensational role-playing epic. the tremendously popular Bonk's Adventure.
Bonk? Forget about the North American cover art. Started it
all. Bonk's Revenge, the smash hit sequel with more power and badder bosses. The turbo chip game Ninja Spirit.
Yeah, getting this many games as a pack-in would have been pretty cool at the time, honestly.
And last but not least, Gate of Thunder.
And yo, Gate of Thunder, the soundtrack whips. Gate of Thunder and Lord of Thunder. Oh God, I gotta play those games.
You'll also receive Turbo Force, the official CD magazine packed with facts, hints, news, and reviews of the hottest Super CD games and breakthrough CD technology. But it doesn't stop there. Turbo Duo includes a valuable coupon book.
Coupon book?
On Turbo Duo products totaling as much as $50.
You mean I can save money if I spend more money? Oh man, I'd be super not to.
Super CD mega hits. Let the games begin.
Oh god, all the rotating images and 3D shit, it's great.
In Prince of Persia, you must hurry, Effendi. You have
oh no, they're doing the... I heard an Indian accent once and I'm ready to do it.
From the clutches of an evil minister. 2 megabit
action. Ah, the 90s.
You may wish...
I told you this would be painfully 90s.
In Gate of Thunder, lasers flash, planets clash, and there's only one person crazy enough to take on a gang of galactic killers marauding your planet. You! 2 megabit
oh, I thought he was going to say it was someone else.
Like the first, with easy, hard, and devil level
no, this is not supported by the Intel Bleep technology.
Surf's up and whoa, so's the pollution, dude.
Is that Wally Bear? Is that Wally Bear famous from the No Gang?
The California environment in Camp California. Way cool Beach Boy tunes accompany this CD hit. Sounds, you have been transformed in Shadow of the Beast. Barehanded, you must confront medieval
what?
Monsters and...
Was this like Turbo Duo trying to do their own take on Altered Beast?
The 2 megabit graphics and sound are truly wondrous.
This feels extremely Altered Beast.
Not even the cops scared a crime boss who's got this
city. Riot City, definitely not Streets of Rage. What's Streets of Rage? I don't know.
Riot City. It's just you and your pal.
It's definitely not Streets of Rage. We have never heard of that in our life.
Lots of luck.
Adventure.
In Shapeshifter, the power to gross. Change your shape is your only hope against the forces of the Dark Ones. Fantastic backgrounds, sound.
Yeah, Streets of Rage 4 DLC is coming soon.
All shape up to an incredible epic adventure.
Apparently, you can play as what's her name? The one, God,
in Dragon
the cop lady,
auto battle mode
and then there's two other characters, which I think might just be the two antagonists, but we'll see. Or maybe Sheba.
Enemy. Experience incredible CD graphics and sound as you grow from young warrior to legendary.
Experience anime.
Once long ago, there lived a guild of weavers.
A lot of people like this game. I've never actually played Loom.
Transcended mere cloth and fabric. Lucasfilm magic recalls the days of dragons and sorcery.
I didn't play a ton of the old adventure games.
To rescue your guild and the universe from unspeakable catastrophe.
Yeah, Mool.
The ancient Greeks called her Gaia, goddess of the earth. Now you can put Gaian theory to the test.
It's so weird. It's so weird seeing that when I'm too used to the Evo Gaia. Gaia.
Even civilization itself. Good luck, but beware, destroy the earth, and Gaia will be very upset.
Dungeon Explorer 2.
Dungeon Explorer 2. Only this time.
I gotta say, these graphics, like, for the time, would have been pretty cool. The little anime cutscenes would have been hype as hell.
Over vast landscapes to take on the forces of evil.
Yeah, Lords of Thunder.
Cross some nasty looking villains before, but you've never gone head to pincers.
What is the soundtrack?
Lords of Thunder. But take heart,
wait, why aren't they playing the actual soundtrack to the game?
The ultimate weapon. Fight your way through 7 levels of unbelievable shooting action.
Why are they just putting all these Star Wars gunshots over? That game has a gas soundtrack. Why would they not do that?
This time it's no more Mr. Nice Feet.
Who would do that? Who would strip the soundtrack from Lords of Thunder?
Ferocious Frenchies, terrifying trap jaws, and maniacal mighty ducks? Sure you are, because you're a Zonk.
Oh, that's the Japanese version.
Powerful
size of your own.
Still got the Japanese markers on it. How could they not get the rights for the soundtrack? It's their game. Oh, yo, hold up. Let's take a look at this screen transition one more time. Whoop, whoop. It is literally coming to life. Oh my god, that's... I've been enlightened.
Top Secret. It's the third in a series of smash hits featuring that prehistoric headbanger.
Yeah, Zonk is kind of like the shooter slash future version of Bonk.
Play together as you get small, get big, and bonk your way through hours of side-splitting, head-bashing fun. It's called the Super System Card, and it's your ticket to a new world of gaming excitement.
It's your ticket to the system upgrade that can't play these games otherwise, so you have to buy it.
Power Plus. CD Power Plus, new
oh my god, hold up.
Super CD technology.
Just taking that one kid with the controller. There we go. That's the 90s. This right here. You could, like, distill this. If you could just turn this into liquid and inject it into my body, I would immediately reverse aging.
Power Plus, new TurboGrafx Super CD technology.
Yo, Nightman, thank you for the resub. I will not stop broadcasting you as a child, no. You and your bowl cut are here forever.
You're great.
With sharper graphics, faster
please
action,
stop broadcasting me as a child.
Better sound and more realistic animation than ever before.
And Talkly, thank you for the resub as well. Oh, thank you.
You're great.
$65, you can choose the Super System
Super CD technology.
For $95, you can get a Super CD containing no less than three games. Gate of Thunder, Bonk's Adventure, and Bonk's Revenge. Not to mention a coupon booklet worth $50 for savings on any Turbo.
Tell me what the coupons are for, though.
Make your
what are the coupons? I want to see the coupons.
The Turbo Duo. One machine powerful enough to take you to the ultimate gaming experience.
Multimedia.
And personal enough to take you one step beyond into a world.
Oh my god, it's like a bowling alley came to life and served as the background for this video. Look at this.
Interfaces with your personal computer to run CD-ROM discs. And even let you sing along to your own karaoke CD.
Can I get another take on that? Okay, hold up. First of all, Robust Laser, thank you for the tier 1 sub, actually, first one. It is much appreciated. I want to get another line of reading on the guy saying karaoke.
And even let you sing along to your own karaoke CD.
Karaoke.
And even let you sing along to your own karaoke CD.
Gonna do some Rue combos while singing karaoke.
That is coming to you for a long time. Step up to the power you deserve. When it comes to intense gaming excitement, there are only two words you need to know. Turbo Duo Power.
And, like, I'm aware that it's supposed to be pronounced karaoke, if you really want to be accurate, but, like, most in North America would pronounce it as karaoke. But karaoke, that's a new one. Yeah, that's one of the VTubers. Alright, this is Donkey Kong hitting on 90s chicks at the 94 VSDA Expo. Oh, this is a big one, holy shit.
That's the sound of my heart.
And this one apparently has Donkey Kong in real time. Oh shit, that's Sunrace FX. Well, this isn't a convention. This is like a trade show. Jorts. We got jorts. This is the VSDA Expo. E3 didn't actually exist yet. E3 didn't exist until 1995. It's gotta be the Donkey Kong setup. Super Game Boy. Oh shit. Oh man. I want to go to here. Actually, hang on. I think I might be getting a... Yeah, here we go. One sec. There's Donkey Kong. Forgot, since this is a regular, it's a square aspect video. There's American Kirby. We finally managed to get somebody to play stunt race effects. I wonder where this exists. Like, where is this car right now? I want that. I wanna play video games inside of a car. Jorts! We got jorts! Jort. I gotta set up an alert for every single jort that shows up. What, I have so much nightmare fuel? Cause this is what we live through, man! This was our life. Not actually here, but... completely abandoned Wario's Woods Cabinet, oh man. That ginormous Game Boy set up too, oh man. Yeah, this is like, it's super washed out, but like, this is probably the best you can get at the time. She's handing out VHSs! What VHSs? Oh my god, it's Guile. Holy shit, that's Guile! Yo, that's Guile, right? This is Guile. He's gonna do a sonic boom. He's holding back right now. So the second he gets off the setup, he's gonna throw a sonic boom or flash kick if you try to jump in on him. Yeah, he must have gotten a break from the Street Fighter booth or something. Yeah, I wanna bump up the audio a little bit here. So I think Donkey Kong's coming up soon. Hi, Guile! Oh, man. Is that Jort? I can't tell if that's Jort's. Aw, Illusion of Gaia. Tiny little Illusion of Gaia setup. It's in the glass case. Nope, hold on. Audio jungle. Oh, I want swag. I want 80 cup. Oh my god, Donkey Kong, no.
Yeah, I think I just went to heaven. Oh, what's your name, beautiful? Will you marry me? How are you today?
Oh no, Donkey Kong, no.
No, oh, baby. But don't you hear
Donkey Kong apparition sucked me off?
My heart, baby.
Is that Charles Martinet?
Love. Two beautiful baby.
That's Charles Martinet. Oh my god, let him out of there. Get him out. Charles Martinet, why? Why is Charles Martinet hooked up to this apparatus? Get him out.
Oh, please come back to me, baby. There you are. You came back.
Charles Martinet's so horny. Oh, this sucks so bad.
Oh, she's back. She's back and she's proud.
Oh, this sucks so bad.
Oh, you ready to swing with me now? I knew you loved me, Carrie. I knew it.
Please.
Oh, filming me.
Oh, I didn't need to see Donkey Kong doing a fucking gasm face today.
Oh, hello, baby. Are you ready to swing from my vine?
No! Cancelled!
You never have. Oh, baby.
So, like, what does he do if a guy steps in front? Does he also harass them? Like, I'm horrified, but I can't stop watching. I can't stop watching the Donkey Kong apparition. Maybe this vine swings both ways. That'd actually be really good.
Like butter. Oh yeah, baby. Who loves you, baby?
Oh stop, it's like shitty Austin Powers. It's like if Austin Powers was an ape. Like more so.
Cement for everybody's needs. Oh baby.
Wait, what about cement? What about X-Men? Hold on. The seven blo- I, they cut out at the wrong time.
She wanted something. I was just gonna whisper sweet nothings into her ear.
Charles.
She kept doing me for something, and I didn't know what to do.
Charles, no.
I was just gonna whisper sweet nothings in her ear like this, Bruce. Donkey Kong.
Donkey Kong Country. Oh, no, no, no. Don't like the eyes rolling back.
Stunt Race FX, baby. Are you getting hot yet? Tin Star, baby. I'm talking the future.
I think... Maybe I'll make this my new... If you donate over, like, $1,000 to me, I will play the entirety of this.
Gaia, baby. Tetris 2. Oh, sweet nothings. Super Punch Out. Ooh, ooh, ooh. Babe.
I hate this. I hate this. I hate this.
My feet are right underneath there. Sure, show us. Give a little tour of the whole place, Eric.
I'm taking poison damage in real life right now.
One question for you. Who loves you, baby? Yeah, you know it, baby. You know it. Well, oh, come back and see me.
Oh, God. Mario wasn't this horny. I saw a video of him doing this as Mario, and he wasn't that horny. Yeah, for some reason, this characterization didn't stick around. I'm taking D.O.T. Donkey Overtime. Oh, we're going to say hi to Charles Martinet. So you're responsible for this. You're the ringleader. Charles Martinet and his jorts. Oh, God.
It's the real thing, baby.
Now she's in your box.
She's in my box. We're now for real.
I hate this. She's in my box.
Okay, we'll leave you some privacy.
This is the alternate timeline where Donkey Kong was an unrepentant pervert. Oh boy. Took a lot of damage from that one. Gonna have to heal. Who loves you, baby? This is, yeah, there's like a minute more of this one. You can still hear him. You can still hear him from across the room. Meanwhile, the Sonic and Knuckles booth, oddly refined, like very professional. It's a dude in suit telling people about Sega and Sega products, not trying to hit on anybody. No Sonic in the background asking if you would like to grab his ring. And scene. All right. So this one's
up next is another video brought to us by Nintendo Power for none other than Star Fox 64.
So this video
is sealed, so I won't be able to take it out of the packaging for you. But if I remember correctly, this is one of the cheesier videos that Nintendo put out, and you'll see in a moment. But it says launch date June 30th, 1997. Got a picture of Fox and the R-Wing fighter.
I'll let the
Star
narration
Fox
go.
64 logo on both sides here. And on the back, kind of hyping up the Rumble Pack here. Check out the new Rumble Pack. See how it feels to feel what you see. Brought to you by Nintendo Power. And now we've got the www.nintendo.com address there. So let's see how it feels to feel what you see. Star Fox 64.
And now, your feature presentation from Nintendo Power.
Just making sure we're not getting cut off here.
The
eagle has landed. I repeat, the eagle has landed.
I'm on him.
So this one is a little more of the infamous ones. Shout out to the diaper service van.
You got the time.
Sure, it's,
the famous Nintendo diaper service van. So this is like the tail end of the directly attacking other companies phase of the console wars.
We'll ask the questions around here.
Do you, have to talk into that thing?
Word on the street is you got a new Nintendo 64 game coming out.
Sega and Sony are going to kill this man from Nintendo.
New games coming out. Star Fox 64.
I like the Sega guy.
About Star Fox 64, eh?
Yeah, and you'd better
the Sony guy would absolutely not be threatened by the Sega man.
Or else what?
This is when the Saturn was being a colossal failure.
Hammer boy here. Get.
What are you guys doing with Mario?
You're killing Mario.
No. Leave Mario out of this.
It's alright. Mario died like over 20 years later anyways. He's dead now. Rest in peace.
Okay. You've made your point. Star Fox 64 is the highly advanced combat game for the
Donkey
Nintendo
Kong
64.
Is not canceled, unfortunately.
The Fox team includes Fox McCloud and his wing.
Yeah, Mario died to protect the secrets of Star Fox 64.
Slippy Toad and Falco Lombardi. The team is sent on missions to destroy Andross, the mad scientist who declared war on the entire Lylat system. This sounds like a fun bunch, but what do these guys drive?
Yeah, some beat up B-52.
It almost, like, I almost wonder if Nathan Barnett used these guys for Keith Apicary. He just kind of, like, merged them together.
For missions, for air battles, you've got the R-Wing. Check this out. This vehicle comes with all the latest cool moves. You can do barrel rolls, make U-turns, it can even do some...
U-turns? My car can do that!
You can lock onto your enemies before blowing them away. And for battles on land, you've got the Landmaster tank.
Mario BLJ'd in the crossbow shot for Grumpy.
Rolls over enemy obstacles.
No, they can see this footage. He's projecting it with his mind.
You've got this submarine called the Blue Marine.
Oh yeah, the Blue Marine. This only got used in a single stage in the game.
It fires torpedoes that light up the dark areas for better vision before taking out the enemy in front of you.
I almost wonder if they wanted to use the Blue Marine in more stages, but they couldn't.
Listen to the real-time dialogue.
You're not getting away that easy.
Let's go for the four hatches on the underside.
Kind of makes you feel like you're part of the game, doesn't it?
Wow, this really is the coolest game out there.
You see?
Why is that Sega guy from Minnesota now? It's a cool-ass game out there, don't you know?
You don't know the half of it. What? There's more?
Well, yeah. But Bob would kill me if I told you.
Not Bob. They already killed Mario. Don't put more blood on your hands.
We have to get this Bob guy to tell us himself.
Bob.
Pizza for Bob. Bob. Are you, Bob?
Yeah, Bob. But, I didn't order any pizza.
Pizza.
This is good pizza.
Peter, glad you could join us. Bob, your test.
Can't believe Peter sold out his friend Bob. 64.
Peter?
Just like Tim Allen.
You didn't tell him about the Rumble Pack, did you?
No. Bob. You just did.
I did.
You did.
Spill it, bit boy.
God.
With pleasure.
Oh, is it time for Mario CBT?
Look at your little plumber boy now.
What are you doing?
Yeah, shock his balls.
Mario doll hooked up to the battery cable concert, Ted. That's enough. All right.
Can't believe Mario is dead again.
This is the Rumble Pack. the big reason why Star Fox 64 is the coolest cinematic gaming experience there is.
Yeah, this video is how they got the little bit from Sonic Adventure 2, where it's like, you just told me, Fox boy.
Wait a second. You're telling me that this Rumble Pack actually lets players feel the game?
The game?
Like you're actually in the cockpit, flying.
I don't remember if the DualShock came out before this.
Nuh-uh. Hook it up.
I think the DualShock. I think it was like shortly after this. Also, this needed batteries, so tough shit if you needed. If you didn't have any batteries, but you still wanted Rumble.
Like when you turbo boost or you shoot a bomb, the Rumble Pack feeds back a slight turbulent vibration.
Boom!
I actually felt it.
We can't show you this, but trust us, there's Rumble. Hold up, we got Dubs Art. We got Dub Art. I think that's Dub Art. Hold up. Dub Art. Yo, DK. Remember when you were a pervert? Oh, damn, I gotta reset the transform on this. Remember when you were a pervert? Yeah. He's changed now. He was a different person. He was a different ape. Oh, shit. Thank you, Dubs. It depended on what you were doing in the game. Like, some areas shook a lot less. Shrink this back down. Recrop this. I want to set up just a dedicated YouTube crop, but I need to change the aspect ratio constantly. I'll just stretch this out like this, because it's not using the sides.
More of a vibration.
Cool.
What's even cooler is when you crash your vehicle, that's when you really feel the vibration.
When you die, incredible. You actually feel something for the first time in your life.
You into a little multiplayer action? Let's get ready to rumble.
Gentlemen, welcome to Versus Mode! Up to four players at once.
So, like, I think I played Versus Mode with my brother twice? Total?
This is fantastic! Now, can you play this on Sega Saturn?
Nope. Only on Nintendo 64. Well, what about PlayStation? Can you play this game
it's,
on that system?
No. Like, it just was pretty boring. The coolest part was probably the fact that you could go on foot if you put in the code, but only in some levels.
What?
You mean there's more?
Yep. Check this out.
Also, fun fact about the Rumble Pack in GoldenEye, this is a good segue, they originally wanted to have you reload by taking out the Rumble Pack and putting it back in real quick. Also, there's the unused Bonds. Unused James Bond is there. Mischief Makers. I gotta play this game again. I haven't played this in forever. I mean, probably just from a general health of hardware standpoint, it was not a good idea. Like, the connectors would almost certainly get really, really weak over time. Oh man, look at those legs. Look at those legs. Oh no, it absolutely would have damaged it if they were constantly doing that. Like, kids have no sense of right or wrong. They will just yank that shit in and out. So that absolutely makes sense that they said, no, you're not doing that. Ha 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 ha! Ronaldinho Soccer! Man, it feels like it's actually been forever since the Ronaldinho Soccer meme last year. Oh, Beta Zelda.
And that is one killer lineup.
Boy, are we in big trouble.
We just can't beat you guys.
Yeah, well... As much as we'd love to stick around here...
And then Sony released the PS2 and completely annihilated Nintendo for, like, a long time.
Sorry, guys. Oh, by the way, have you seen this? What's that? That's a Star Fox 64 Player's Guide. It teaches you everything you need to know about the game. Let me see that. You can buy it at the store.
Damn!
Or, If you want more gaming information, check us out on the web.
Yeah, Sony. Oh, yeah, that's right. They got Final Fantasy. AKA the game that put RPGs on the map.
Guys.
See you later, boys.
And now Nintendo are the psychopaths. Anyways, please purchase Star Fox 64. I guess. You can buy it at the store. Yeah, PlayStation did very, very well. Speaking of PlayStation, perfect segue. Was that Kingsfield? No. How long is this guy? 10 minutes? Yeah, GameCube didn't have a DVD player. Oh, that looks cool.
What's that?
Oh man, this is apparently pre-launch, so. This must have been. I think King's Field was a launch title, actually.
Now see the outstanding technical capabilities of Sony's advanced video game system, and how game developers the world over can now create a stunning new generation
of
interactive entertainment.
It's tapes time. That's right, Tina.
The PlayStation delivers over 500 MIPS worth of processing power.
Jumping Flash
chipset. It features dedicated graphics engines, CD quality audio, double speed CD-ROM, and motion video as standard.
Harnessing that's a lot of MIPS. MIPS stands for million instructions per second.
Multi-channel DMA, an ultra high.
I feel like this is an actual. That was an actual footage though. That was probably like a mock-up. That seemed way too smooth.
60,000 sprites per second.
Oh my god.
A variety of screen resolutions.
Oh my god! Look at all these orbs.
480 with 15 or 24 bit color.
Oh, that looks great on the compression.
Scaled, morphed.
Oh, I love these tech demos that are just like a bunch of balls or some shit bouncing around.
Transparent and overlaid.
Oh shit, this is the bomb that Ty and all them tried to solve in Keep Talking, Nobody Explodes.
Sophisticated multi-plane scrolling effects to be performed. The PlayStation custom three-dimensional graphics hardware is a true polygon system with many special effects as standard.
I mean, they are talking this up, but the alternative was quads that the Saturn used.
Polygon
Saturn didn't do so hot.
Transparency, Gorard shading, texture mapping, 16, 256, or 32,000 colors.
Oh baby, look at all these cubes.
And fading. Any or all of which can be combined.
Oh, it's like the PS2 startup screen. Oh shit. Yeah, this is like the epitome of tech demo stuff, just like a bunch
multiple
of shapes and stuff.
Can be used to add further subtlety and quality.
Yeah, we got a cone now. Hell yeah.
Lights can be defined by their RGB color, their XYZ position. Objects and lights can be moved in real time. And also work with texture mapped images.
Whoa.
Ambient light can also be controlled for the brightness of the whole scene.
No, no way.
The PlayStation contains sophisticated animation technology to permit complex multiple frame animations to be efficiently controlled and manipulated in real time.
Man, I'm just watching these and thinking.
Impact with the walls.
This would have been. The video source says 95. Multiple I think the PS1 was released in 1994, though.
Together to produce very realistic results.
I will say for early PS1, this actually looks pretty decent.
The animation system also allows very natural movement to be included in game designs.
Yeah, they probably shouldn't have said realistic when the cartoon guy was walking around, though. Like, that's good. That actually looks pretty good. I want to say that's a guy from Motortune.
A standard feature of the PlayStation is high-quality motion video playback from CD.
I love you when you rap!
Video.
You ever want to watch Ghostbusters on an orb?
And manipulated in real time. In addition to playing standard CD audio within games, the PlayStation has a 20.
These guys have some hell of traps going on. Jesus Christ! Look at the workout.
Both sample and waveform playback. Sound special effects include pitch modulation, waveform envelope.
This is a, sample. This reminds me of the digital reverb. What's it called? The bodybuilders in FF7.
The features of the PlayStation allow developers to create demonstrations like this.
Show me some games. It's Ridge Racer! Remember that one?
3, 2, 1, go!
Oh, baby. Look at that early 3D. Yeah, this was like 94. I think this was after Virtua Racer. Or Virtua Racing, I should say. Virtua Racing was kind of the big one that kickstarted a lot of that. And Daytona. Yeah, 94 was the same year as Super Metroid. PlayStation came out really early. Like, a lot earlier than people think. And yeah, the fact that there was, like, altitude adjustments and stuff going up and down, real-time models and stuff like that, and not just, like, pre-made sprites. It is very easy to look back now and be like, oh man, this looks like trash, but you gotta remember. Like, obviously, you go back and play Battle Arena Toshinden now, it's gonna be like, oh boy, this game is... Why would I play this? But this is all we really had. Like, check that. Did you see that orb? Did you see that real-time rendering on the orb? Like, I am half laughing at these, but also, like, you do have to actually respect them for what they did at the time. Got a Japanese version of this new bookcase. Man, AG, you suck.
Cyber Sled.
Oh, baby, Cyber Sled.
Alan Stryker. Ready? Go!
Namco was big on the early adoption stuff. That's a sled. This is a Cyber Sled. It's like an arena... I think Virtual On came out before this, but it's kind of a similar concept. I want to say Virtual On was afterwards. Almost similar to Faceball as well. Well, this came out before Twisted Metal, so... I think this came out before Twisted Metal, pretty sure. I mean, there were a bunch of, like, arena-style games similar to this, like, Spectre, Faceball 2000. But, yeah, like, a lot of the examples people are giving, it's like Armored Core. Armored Core didn't exist yet. Like, obviously, if you have the option to play Virtual On or Oratorio Tangram, then yes, play that. Oh, this is Motor Tune. I played this in a hotel room once. It's all right. This was one of the games that they gave you like 15 minutes of time, then you had to pay money. Because that's a monetization model that worked, I guess, if you had kids in a hotel. You wanted to keep them interested in stuff. Keep them occupied, you have to make them pay. Or make the parents pay, let's be honest here. This is very loud. But yeah, like, that was a pretty common model where the TVs would be explicitly set up to only allow the hotel hookups. Like, you couldn't plug in your own thing. I remember I went on a band trip in, like, 2002, 2003 to Cleveland, and I brought my GameCube thinking, oh, we'll play some Smash Brothers at the hotel. Nah, didn't let us hook it up. Oh god, look at that warping. We don't actually make the model turn, we just stretch it as make it appear as though it's turning. It was a band trip. We went to go see the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame. Yeah, it's kind of wild to think most of these are pre-release. Let's fade out before Infogrames sure like it fully fills up there. Nobody needs to see Infogrames. God, Infogrames just did not make very good games. Ah! Now I'm scared. They put a T-Rex at the end, and now I'm worried I'm going to get eaten. He has to struggle. Well, Square Enix, I don't think they really had much. I think they were still with Nintendo at the time, right? They were probably still not super big on Sony yet. Anyways, this is a news report on Pokemania.
When we come back, what all the fuss is about, at
this
least
is from 1999.
The 8-year-old set in this country.
Bring all your skill.
This must have been when the movie came out, I think, because that shot's from the movie.
The hottest thing in the 12 and under set is coming soon to a theater near you. Pokemon the movie joins Pokemon the video game and Pokemon the trading card as much.
At least they're saying Pokemon right.
Haves.
Not Pokemon.
Off tonight, NBC News correspondent.
Oh, look at that chufty Pikachu!
The craze that is now hit.
Look at chufty Pikachu.
More than a game.
Anybody know how to play this? How to get to the next level?
Or a TV show. Pokemon is an undeniable.
That's a perfect segue. Does anybody know how to play this stupid game?
The upcoming Pokemon the first
shit.
Movie recently caused such a frenzy that the switchboard at Warner Brothers was flooded with 70,000 calls a minute from people desperate for tickets. The animated Japanese import created by Nintendo also holds the top 5 video game slots. So what exactly is a Pokemon? Cute, cuddly characters who become supercharged.
They are servants of Satan.
Fight their enemies. But some experts say the entire Pokemon phenomenon is the enemy.
In my opinion, parents should not let their kids watch Pokemon, play Pokemon.
Of course her last name is Lieberman. God damn it.
Have anything whatsoever to do with Pokemon because the message is violence.
But
violence.
Many parents disagree.
Violence.
It's really, I think, an okay thing for the kids because they learn to save their allowance, to budget for it, and
learn
to trade and be kind of reasonable with their friends.
When it comes to the biggest
trying to blame
Pokemon
everything
phrase,
on video games, cause of violence.
This 747 arrived today from Tokyo.
Yeah, that's violent. Look how violent that jet is.
Collectible cards. Many school officials.
Look at this violent beast.
Gone too far.
They're not allowed at our school because it's such a craze, and people like them so much they tend to steal.
School officials.
Okay, to be fair, people did actually steal Pokemon cards though. That was true. That was 100% true. We would have Pokemon cards get stolen at our school, and then you weren't allowed to play them. I think we were allowed to play Game Boys, but cards, I think, yeah, you could not bring those.
Pokemon cards are responsible for fistfights, and the constant trading is not only distracting kids from classwork, but turning the playground into a black market where they buy and sell rare cards.
Wow, all those.
Just
hey, I'm actually kind of curious, real quick. Let's open up a tab here. Charizard First Edition Mint. No. $1,108, $4,045, $13,000, $620. I don't think this is the right one. $1,700. This isn't even the right one. They're trying to sell it for that much. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
How long will this fad last? Retailers hope well into the holiday shopping season.
Now this Pokemon thing is not going to last.
NBC News, Los Angeles.
If you have or know a young child, then you may know that bonding moments with children these days come only when they look up from their Pokemon cards or other products. As we've established, it's the thing with the younger age set. Here to walk us through what adults should know, the self-proclaimed toy guru, Ira Gallen. He's the owner of Video Resources in New York. Ira, to you and Pikachu, a hearty good evening.
And this is going to be one of the hottest selling toys for the holidays. This is a talking Pikachu from Hasbro Toys, not even in the stores yet. It's going to be in next month.
I don't think this Pokemon thing is going to catch on.
That how bad Pokemon is, I guarantee you these people haven't seen any of the cartoons at all. They have no concept at all.
Well, let's get into this.
True.
Because as I understand it from my own child,
is that Pokemon Monopoly? Hell yeah.
One of my children.
How old are they?
My son who's into it is 8, and he's walked me through it, and it's all about battles, is it not?
Not really. In fact, I got to tell you, I get this episode today. Pokemon.
It is kind of about battles, though, let's be honest.
Pokemon. That aren't treated well by their trainers. Because in the Pokemon world, in the age of 10, you get to be able to go to Pokemon school and be given a...
Like, it's not
Pokemon
like violent battles, but it
Pokemon.
Is about battles.
Now, okay,
but some kids are... Wait, I gotta tell you, but some kids are bad and treat their Pokemon bad and they're abused.
Oh, he
this
just
is
said
a great
Pokemon.
Episode about abused characters that have to go to a special resort to get better and meet better kids to grow with.
Now, the next question concerns
Pokemon. I love when people say things
as
wrong.
As you know, you can now buy a Furby in the dairy case at your local supermarket. Half
and
price,
I got to tell you, Furby
were.
Is still selling well. They're expecting good sales with Furby. But in fact, Tiger Toys, all the Furbies, have all the electronic toys for...
But is Pikachu going to become the Furby of 1999?
Pretty much. There's certain...
Now Furby, that's going to be lasting well until the 2000s, the end of the
2000s. You have to have a Pokedex. And this is by Tiger Toys, and you can... This is like a Rolodex for every...
This guy is just selling all of it. He's just shilling all of his stuff.
Put in the code number of that Pokemon, you get to learn about it. Every one of these at Warner Brothers store and FAO Schwarz totally sold out.
Well, they're an absolute necessity, I
imagine. Mean, to be fair, Furby in 1998 was absolutely like the hottest toy by far.
Out with 57 toys, among them the ultimate Pokeball. I guarantee your son's going to want this. This is $1.99 at Burger King when you buy one of the value meals and you get your special gold card. There's 6 of these. There are 150 additional Pokemon cards, and there's no way every kid is going to get all the toys at Burger King. So
yeah, I think a friend of mine had one of these.
Of all these cards as well. So you're going to find kids trading a lot of these things.
Now, Iro, how do you answer the question? Is this just toy collectibles? Is it a movement? Is it a craze? Is it a state of being?
It's a craze for little kids to enjoy themselves with. Adults are not going to get into this a lot. But what's interesting is...
There will never be an adult that enjoys Pokemon.
Left and right. I own 50,000 of them. I wouldn't watch any of this stuff. I throw on a tape over the weekend, which I got to recommend people. I choose Pikachu. This will explain to everybody what the craze is about. In fact, Pioneer Electronics buys the rights
He's
to
just
DVD
selling
the
all
videos.
This shit.
They're now giving one away with all their DVD players with 50%.
Oh, right. This is when DVDs first started getting popular.
Because kids want the DVD versions. I think through the holidays, guaranteed, and I can probably guarantee you there's another year and a half to this craze.
All
it
right.
hasn't even peaked yet.
All right.
Year and a half, tops.
Always, Ira Gallen, thank you. Thank your many little friends
for
coming on the air. Thank you. Please do. You know where to send.
What this guy is doing now if he still owns a toy shop?
He's making headlines in tomorrow morning's newspapers across the country.
Who wants to watch The Simpsons at 300 times speed? All right, now it's time for some Segata Sanshiro commercials. As soon as I fix the aspect ratio here.
Okay.
Also, this has subtitles.
Segata Sanshiro!
Fucking destroy those children. Play the Sega Saturn, you piece of shit. So this is arguably one of the most endearing and long-lasting aspects about the Saturn. I'm not playing the Sega Saturn right now. This is what happens when you do not play the Sega Saturn. A man will come to the club where you're having fun and just break your neck. Anyways, here's Bomberman. Yeah, they kind of laid off the Segata Sanshiro just beating people up after a bit. Because they realize, oh shit, that's maybe a little much. Oh god, that mask is terrifying. No children were backdropped during the making of this commercial. Is this the same one? What if they put the same one in twice? Oh, this is the extended version where he makes them cry. That was the only difference. He makes the kids cry in this one. Oh man. What inspired campaign? Play our console or we'll snap your neck and make your children cry. He died at the end of this, spoiler alert, he's died at the end of these commercials, like the character dies. And then I think they might have brought him back in the new set. But yeah, he's got a son now, apparently. Like, I know it's his son, I just don't know if they brought the original actor back to do a bit as well. Yeah, there is in fact lore behind this guy now. This is when they kind of entered their groove. He got a theme song. Solo Crisis. I have never heard of that game. It's gotta be Panzer Dragoon. Panzer Dragoon RPG, Azero. Sega Saturn. You guys playing Sega Saturn in here? Oh shit, Burning Rangers. She's dead. It actually brought back the Burning Rangers event in PSO2 recently. Like after being absent for like 4 or 5 years? Ow. Oh, it's gonna be House of the Dead? Need a gun. You need a gun. Yeah. House of the Dead. I think this actually post with that image went viral recently. Your immune system after getting the COVID vaccine, just a billion Segata Sanshiros. Is that allowed? World Cup 98. I've never seen that done, but maybe that's allowed. Yeah, he got a red card, but like, maybe he got away with it? Maybe it's worth it? Oh god, is this Soccer Wars? No, she's not playing Sega Saturn. She's not playing Sega Saturn, you gotta take her out. Sorry, Sakura Tyson. Didn't they release one of them recently in English? I think it was actually like the first one in the series that officially came out in English recently. Like within the past few years. No, not fan translated, like an actual official release. Is it not great? I never played the series, so I couldn't tell you. I'll fully work on that meat. Oh, what is... this Deep Fear? Yeah. Sega Saturn. No, there's another really campy FMV game, Blue Stinger, but that one is Blue Fear specifically. Deep Fear has some very good voice acting, by the way. Excuse me. I've never heard of this game. Throwing children on the floor because they didn't buy his game. Official Sega Tessenshiro game. I mean, it makes sense. Why would you not want to make a game of this? It's like Yakuza, except you tell people to play Sega games instead of, like, solving a mystery. Tentative title. Tentative date. Alright, this was right when the Dreamcast started to get announced. I kind of want to play that one game where it's like the Sega simulation, Sega Gaga. I don't know if that has an English patch yet, though. Also, this is where he canonically died. For the first time, at least. Stop the missile from being shot at Sega. Just like Mario. Sega Saturn. Just like Mario. I'm saluting my monitor right now. You can't see it, but I'm doing it. Alright, this is the Pokemon promo VHS. This one actually is in...
You've been selected to receive the sneak peek about a phenomenon called Pokemon, a hit TV show, a Game Boy game, and loads of other cool things that are about to take America by storm!
So this is the promo VHS for Pokemon.
A sneak peek at Pokemon.
This is the official hype machine being advertised here. Also, Audio Jungle. We don't know if this Pokemon thing's gonna happen, but I don't know. It'll probably do okay, I guess. I have to be very careful to constantly talk over this, otherwise it might get dinged. Because I think this was actually on one of the soundtrack CDs, so I probably, if not muted, at the very least it'll get muted. Audio Jungle.
Alright,
so here's Ash's Aunt Hillary.
September 7th, my nephew, Ash, he just turned 10, is the show's star. His dream is to become a Pokemon master.
Pokemon?
This is no easy task.
Anybody want to play some Pokemon?
Ash has to capture all of these little Pokemon things.
Oh, now she said Pokemon. Yeah, this is bits from the anime, which I guess they couldn't keep in the video.
Totally.
Oh, yo. Hold up. I got this Pikachu. I have this Pikachu. I actually found it somewhere. Somebody just left it sitting around and I found it and it's mine now.
Each one is totally different from the other. And are you ready for this? There are 150 of them. And you gotta catch them all.
That's a lot. You know, it's actually really good that they cut out these bits from the video, because I'd probably get dinged for it.
Well, there's Brock. He's a good guy. Ash challenged him once at the gym in Pewter.
Trey and Troy.
But now they're buds, and they're on a journey together.
And then Team Rocket, they're bad. Really bad.
To protect
the world from devastation.
To unite all peoples within our nation.
To denounce the evils
of
truth and love.
To when did he get removed from, like, the main cast? That was after, like, the second season, I think? Second
they
or third?
To steal Pikachu away from Ash to fulfill their evil boss's diabolical plan for total domination.
I will say, watching, like, a clip of the modern series in English is so weird, because all the actors are different.
Speed of light. Surrender now or prepare to fight. Attention!
At your service.
Meowth, Tosher!
Everything is proceeding exactly as I have foreseen. The Pokemon craze is sweeping the world. I want the three of you to catch me the rarest of all Pokemon. Ash Ketchum's Pikachu.
We've been trying.
The rarest of all Pokemon, a Pikachu.
And you better steal Pikachu away from them soon, because the TV show is about to launch, and the Game Boy game, and the toys, the card game, comic books.
I think they used a voice module. This actually might be the real actor. I think that is the actual actor. I don't know.
A bunch of kids who were lucky enough to get their hands on this video.
Well, if they don't play the Game Boy game or watch the TV show, they'll never catch Pikachu.
Well, if they don't buy everything.
Pika who?
I was glad to find out that Ash's first Pokemon
Mr. Carlson
was a little Pikachu. And, okay, Pikachu doesn't like being transported in the Pokeball, and it doesn't talk much, and when it does, all it can say is, Pikachu.
Oh, I don't know. In fiction, it's a cartoon for children.
Electric potential and electromotive forces equal to the difference of a constant current of 1,000 amperes when the power dissipates between...
Somebody started to color in the Poliwhirl here and then just decided now. Yeah, where's Mr. Carlson in the anime? Where's he in the games?
What I like best about Ash and Pikachu, though, is how they bonded. Loyalty. Now, there's a quality you can't teach in the classroom.
Mm-hmm.
Who's the redhead?
Misty met Ash when he took her bike to get Pikachu to a hospital. He got burned to a crisp by one of Pikachu's electrical bolts.
I like this extended universe that they're trying to build here.
Misty
really enriches the experience.
She's got skills of her own. You should see her do battle with her water Pokemon. She really knows her strategy. She's even brave enough to take on Team Rocket all by herself.
I guess I'm gonna have to take this into my own hands. You grab Pikachu and get out of here.
And then she caught a Togepi and didn't really do much of anything else.
That's pretty big talk coming from such a little lady.
At least you're right about the pretty part. Thanks for the compliment.
The girl thinks she's pretty.
I agree with her. I think she's pretty too. Pretty pathetic.
Got him!
I'll show you! Pokeball! Go!
The strategy.
To become a great trainer, Ash has to capture.
To become a great trainer, just pick a psychic type and use psychic. You'll win.
To know, in order to catch them all.
Gotta catch them all!
That's why Professor Oak gave him his first Pokédex. It's the newest model with the latest digital technology that will give Ash instant Pokémon information with greater clarity and better reception than ever before.
Hmm.
I need to upgrade my model.
I am Dexter, personal Pokemon.
Man, this must have been like super exciting at the time. Like, oh man, it's a personal digital assistant that tells us everything about all the Pokemon, and now we have phones. Now we just have things that tell us all this shit and better. Translate stuff in real time.
Many more Pokemon still to be discovered.
Geodudes are really tough.
I agree.
I'm partial to the fire element monsters.
This is a Pokeball.
In the world of Pokemon,
that's a ball.
Are eligible to become Pokemon trainers. Ash received his first.
So it's funny that you mentioned Dinosaur King because my nephew has actually really gotten into the opening song from that show, but just the song.
I will be the greatest Pokemon trainer, the greatest Pokemon master of all time.
I like the fact that capturing a Pokemon takes real skill.
I'm joking about the Intel bleep technology, but it's actually probably going to be used a lot more than you think for a lot of people.
Yes. Yes, I do. I think
it's looking at pictures of pandas.
To become a great Pokemon trainer, Ash must catch as many as possible by battling his own.
I never saw Dinosaur King when it aired, but yeah, my nephew is super into the theme song. Specifically the French version. Not the English version he doesn't like as much. Hold up, there we go.
Like a rock, paper, scissors match. It's all about strategy.
Rock, paper, scissors match.
Including electric, flying, bug, grass, fire, and water, to name a few.
Okay, I was trying to pay attention to see if they were saying bird type. Oh, I had these. I read the shit out of these, though.
Both versions, red and blue. And here's a tip from Dexter. Collecting is the key. The more monsters you collect, the better trainer you will be.
They sent out those little mini magazines as part of Nintendo Power. And, oh boy, I read the shit out of that one.
And that's not all.
Prepare to lose, Troy. You bet, Trey.
Pikachu. I can exercise with it.
Oh, that's right.
Gifts, even watch it.
Little pocket Pikachu toy with a pedometer.
No, there are 150 Pokemon out there. But is there really one Pokemon more adorable than Pikachu? I don't think so.
This is a Pokemon strategy card game.
Oh.
Playing this card.
Whoa.
Think so.
This is a Pokemon strategy card game.
That's the Japanese back. This might have been before they got picked up by... Yeah, that's a Japanese card. This might have been before they got picked up by Wizards of the Coast. But yeah, that's definitely Japanese text on that one.
Playing this card game could help you finesse your Pokemon training skills. And then show them off in battle with others.
I'm collecting the Pokemon...
This is a promo VHS for Pokemon. Just Pokemon in general.
Stay tuned!
You gotta watch Monday through Friday starting September 7th.
And be sure to look on your video's mailing label for the Pokemon TV Showtime and Station. And oh, that must be the Pokecar. And be sure to watch out for it, too.
The Pokecar?
Pokecars will be cruising around giving away lots of free stuff.
Oh, right. I was in Canada, so we never got the Pokecar.
www.pokemon.com.
Pokemon.com. I don't think the Pokemon company existed at this time. It was still Game Freak. Just Game Freak.
Remember, you gotta catch them all.
Gotta catch them all. Pokemon!
You gotta catch all of them. Yeah, probably would have been either Nintendo.
Pokemon headquarters!
Nintendo or Game Freak. Oh man, Toys R Us. Toys R Us. Yeah. Nintendo Creatures, Game Freak. Yeah, Pokemon Company wasn't established until later, when it was very clear that it was not going to be a fad. Used to work there. Oh, hell yeah. ITV News, when it comes to video games and more. All right, video game time. Let's see. I gotta tweak my stuff here. This is the Nintendo 64 release. I'm losing anything at the top there. Whoop. No. Normally I would just use fit to screen, but weird stuff happens in OBS when you try to do that and then crop stuff afterwards, so I'm just going to do this. Highlighted a kid's Pokemon roster during the Diamond Pearl promo. Bits the better, did you at least give the poor kid a Mew? It's as good as it gets.
The icon behind me shows nothing but cloud. We're actually talking about
you didn't even give him
evening
the, what the heck?
Even a chance of wet flowers. If we go down to 4 degrees, it's going to turn white, so your cuddly toys might be a bit soggy.
On the weekend?
Yeah.
I better explain that he's going on a toy run.
Yeah, that's right. Oh, yeah. Those are the toys she's talking about.
Yes.
Well, we'll see what happens. I'll let you know.
You just destroyed a kid's hopes and dreams.
You know, it's not even Halloween yet, but millions of kids already know what they want for Christmas, a new video game system called Nintendo 64.
Nintendo's
that's right.
New game machine is 64.
So this is 1996, specifically, September 29th, apparently.
Bits, making it the most powerful machine on the market. Herb Weisbaum tells us all about it.
Nintendo 64.
Just a few years ago, this was state-of-the-art, flat and two-dimensional, with characters who had very limited movements.
I'm just going to point out right now that we're coming up very close to the Mario Sunshine 20-year anniversary.
With Nintendo 64-bit technology, it's a whole new game. Now
Mario that's the beta. This is the beta version.
World, and you can make him go wherever you want.
Whatever you thought about video games...
That was the beta version. It's the one that's personalized.
It's a whole new experience.
The N64 is truly breakthrough technology. Nintendo took the power of a $100,000 computer workstation and put it into an affordable home game machine. The result? Some of the best video games ever made.
The graphics engine is much tighter.
Is that that's the Killer Instinct theme.
You know, it is really the kind of graphics that we had always hoped that we could see. Well, now we're actually starting to see them.
Clearly, the N64 is a cutting-edge machine, but it will debut with only 2 games. Nintendo promises 10 more by Christmas, and company executives don't seem too worried about the limited library.
The key isn't the number of games, the key is the quality of the games.
Nintendo will spend $54 million to launch its new system, the biggest advertising blitz in company history.
This is it, the power of N64.
Oh, that is extremely beta, Star Fox. Holy shit, look at that HUD.
Upgrading to the N64. Pulling out all the stops,
it looks so weird when you see beta Star Fox, because it looks completely different.
Potential customers.
I mean, even from a jaded gamer's point of view, somebody who has seen thousands of games, they've done things that I've sat up and said, wow, this is pretty neat stuff. And if they can keep that up, yes, you know, I'm going to be one of the first in line.
Yeah, Wii U is,
Just look what happened
we would like not to
the
remember the Wii U.
N64 hit the market. Customers lined up for hours waiting to get one. Nintendo sold 300,000 machines that first day.
Wow.
That's going to drive parents nuts.
Is it ever?
Kids are going to want it. The parents are not going to be able to find it. It's one of those classic Christmas things, and I can't believe we're talking about Christmas already.
I know. You know what? I can hardly figure out paddle pong. I don't know how the kids play this thing. You ever sat down with a kid when they start playing these things?
No, to be fair, the N64 controller was a bit of a nightmare.
Right now for sports night, they look like a couple of electronic game players.
You play Nintendo?
No.
No, you know what? Do I?
Well, I can, but not very well.
Have you ever played Space Invaders?
Wait. Wait, did they play Space Invaders? Hold up. I want to know if they played Space Invaders. Go back. You need to let them answer. Oh. All right, so this is an hour plus of commercials, so we're probably not going to watch the entire thing, but we'll definitely watch a few of them. Also, I apologize in advance if there's any flashing in the video or whatever. There you go. Support this channel on Patreon. coffee for Binky. Oh my god. Wait, is this... These are commercials, right? These are commercials that we opened up. All right. We're getting there. Finally, not a YouTuber, but in television. How long is this intro?
Here's an easy question for you. Which of these games is the closest thing to the real thing? A, right. In television, Major League Baseball.
Ooh.
B, Atari Baseball.
I'm going to go with neither for 1,000, Alex.
Close up. A, in television. B, Atari.
I want to hear that realistic ref one more time.
You're absolutely correct. Here they are again, close up.
Listen to that ref.
A, in television. B, Atari.
You're out.
All right. If you thought A, in television, you're absolutely correct. You see, I told you this question was easy.
So what if I said B, though? What if I said Atari? What then?
Television space game Star Strike with one of the most popular Atari games, Asteroids. Star Strike has moving images that make the game appear three-dimensional. Asteroids doesn't.
Fuck you, Asteroids.
Star Strike features our most exciting visual effect.
We're like Asteroids. Oh, wait, shit.
This is what the other game offers, which is why, after Star Strike, Asteroids left me rather flat. Star Strike, new for Intellivision from Mattel Electronics.
Like, Intellivision did decent, if I remember.
Plimpton.
I bet it's great doing all those Intellivision commercials. I bet you get to keep all the games. Me and my friends like Night Stalker the best. That's a real scary.
Here, your friends won't have this new one. Lock and Chase.
I won't believe this. Would you autograph it for me?
Certainly.
Lock and What's Chase for the Intellivision?
My name?
Wait.
You're Mr. Intellivision.
Why do they cut it there? Is there a...
My friend wants an Intellivision because...
Is there an Intellivision cinematic universe that I have to be aware of?
The other video game because it's cheaper. Could you do something about the price?
Dear, what was his name? I think I have something that'll make your...
What is this kid's name? Why are they not telling me the kid's name?
The people at Mattel Electronics have drastically reduced the size and price.
Yeah, they're gonna reveal his name at the end. It's gonna be Mario.
Has no excuse now.
To turn World War II into a great home video game, you need B-17.
Bombs away! B-17 Bomber! I love that crunchy ass voice on the Intellivision.
From Mattel Electronics. Now get a free Intellivoice module by mail when you buy any Intellivision Master Component.
Oh, that's right. You had to install the voice module separately because it was too much for the game.
Introducing Burger Time, the home video game where you're
oh, man, Burger Time.
To make hamburgers. There's just one problem.
It's a video game about making hamburger.
Out of you.
Hamburger.
For Intellivision, this fall, Atari 2600, Aquarius, Apple II, and IBM personal computer. Burger Time, only from Mattel Electronics.
We're closed now!
Ah.
The Martians are coming!
Yes, and Mario is your only hope!
Oh, look at that Mario.
In Super Mario Land! Guide him on the Nintendo Game Boy!
The weird Mario.
Challenge the mysteries and terrors of ancient Egypt! Battle all the horrors of the deep! Master lots of weird worlds to give Mario a happy ending and make your world a better place.
Oh baby, look at those crunchy models.
Exciting games for Game Boy. Nintendo. Now you're playing with power.
Mario Land was so weird, but I kind of like it. So what was the kid's name? Did they ever reveal that? Does anybody know the Intellivision lore?
You don't stop playing because you get old.
But you What's could this get old soundtrack? Stop playing.
We didn't play some Tetris!
Game Boy from Nintendo.
Oh god, this is like distilled 90s.
But it ain't what you think. He gets to zap these viruses.
Needs some guy in the background screaming, not.
Remember, kids.
Sorry. I got the Dr. Mario infection.
Suddenly the sky is a little clearer. The water is a little bluer.
Yeah, the NES lasted well until I think like 95, 96 was kind of the last days of it when people stopped making games for it, but it lasted a long time. Oh, that's a beta version. It still said Mario Brothers 4. Yeah, Mario World is great still. Sorry. Unless you're Arthur Blues, in which case Super Mario World sucks. Oh, fuck. Wario Apparition sucked me off. Sorry. I'm banned from Twitch now.
Most challenging Game Boy adventure yet.
Obey Wario. Destroy Mario.
Don't fall under Wario's evil spell in Super Mario Land 2.
Who's this Wario guy gonna be?
Let's go racing in Super Mario.
Oh, Yoshi's Funny Car.
Only on Super NES. Turn the track into a giant mud pit. Or burn rubber on ice, wood, or asphalt. Mix it up for the big boys. See Bowser and his Bigfoot chopping truck. See Yoshi's go-kart really.
Bowser's big-ass truck.
Turtle shell. Check your rear view and make him eat dust. Or go into battle mode and ruin his day.
Oh my god.
Only for the Super Nintendo Entertainment System. Now
the flashing. It's a vocoded version of the Super Mario Land 2 ad. I don't know if I'm ready for that. Oh man. Could not make this commercial today. Let's have a bunch of kids flipping around a Super Scope as though it were a gun. No way you can do this commercial today. You'd get in so much trouble. Like, Nintendo especially, of all companies. Oh, baby. Donkey Kong Country. Did Myst come out before Donkey Kong Country? I feel like a lot of games were fully rendered. The problem with fully rendered is that could be a bunch of different things.
Let's see. You were doing 140 in the 35 zone.
Notice how little footage of the game they show in this one.
Carnage. Oh, you didn't use your turn signal, son. I'm gonna have to write you up for that last.
Look how fast you're going. You almost got up to 2 digits of frame rate that time. Only on the Super NES. Gonna have to write you up for that one. Donkey Kong Country 2. Okay, actually, fun story. Maybe not fun, but I'm going to call it a fun story. So a lot of people say Diddy's Kong. It's officially called Diddy's Kong Quest because it's a pun on the word conquest, right? But originally, it used to be Diddy Kong's Quest. There is, in fact, beta footage of this game that says Diddy Kong's Quest. So if you remember the game as Diddy Kong's Quest, you're from the alternate timeline. You had, in fact, fallen through a wormhole from a parallel dimension, and I hate to be the one to break it to you.
Super NES. Donkey Kong Country 2, Diddy's Kong Quest. It's even tougher than the original.
True.
Goalie said my name 52 times. Could have been more, but I spent over 2 minutes.
Well, let me adjust the tracking.
That's the way I play, hard and fast. Like NHL Breakaway 98, with rumble pack checking, high power goal scoring, and the best graphics on.
Yeah, a lot of people thought it was Diddy Kong's Quest, but it's Diddy's Kong Quest because it's a pun on the word conquest.
It's all in the head. The head move.
Well, this is gonna be like late 90s. These kids are aggressively late 90s.
Not bad.
Oh, this is Yoshi's story. Hang on. You want to see Nightmare? You want to see fun? Wadi will show you fun! Hold up.
Not bad. But you gotta work on your follow-through.
Get it going back in. There you go. That's for you at home. That's a bonus. That's not in the video. I give that to you as a treat. Really could just be a Fruit by the Foot commercial, honestly.
For the first time, Winnie the Pooh and all his friends from the 100 Acre Wood are on Game Boy Color. Play the adventure for new Kidco, rated E, Game Boy Color
no.
system sold separately.
Oh shit, Tony Hawk's Pro Skater. Legitimately a very important game. The guy kind of looks like Tony Hawk almost.
Now everyone thinks they can skate like Tony. Now available on Nintendo 64 and Game Boy Color, rated E for everyone.
Actually, here's another fun, weird video game fact about Tony Hawk. He actually edited a demo reel for, I think it was the Turbo Duo or the Turbo CD. Somebody, like, they linked the demo to him on Twitter and, like, did you, this is going to be a weird question, but did you edit this? And he just responds, like, yes, how did you find this? Holy shit. Because apparently he used to do video editing work.
Mario's trapped in a new adventure!
This is legit a really good commercial.
He has new enemies, but will he save the princess? In Paper Mario!
Rated E.
Is it here yet?
No.
Is it here yet?
Nope.
Is it here yet?
No.
Pokemon Gold and Silver.
Is it here yet?
No.
Is it here yet?
No.
Is it here yet?
Let me check. No.
Is it here yet?
Pokemon Stadium 2 will be here on March 28th. Until then,
$10 oh, he's playing Pokemon Gold and Silver.
And get your collector's edition poster with tons of Pokemon. So you'll be ready to battle with your Gold and Silver characters in 3D.
Oh, compression didn't like that video.
Is it here yet?
No.
Rated E for everyone.
Was it really me that introduced you to Pokemon? God. That's kind of wild, actually.
Game Boy Color. You can learn the language. Do the
I thought for sure you would have heard about it before. Damn. This is... Oh, right, this was,
Game Boy Color. Also playable on Game Boy Advance.
This was actually before Ham Ham Heartbreak, right? A lot of people enjoy those games. I never really got to Hamtaro as a franchise. I was into cool stuff like Final Fantasy and Busta Groove. That's a Hadouken. That's a Hadouken and extra shit. Oh man, crunchy Street Fighter, hell yeah. It just came out or it brought to school. God, did I? Oh, that's right, I think I had my Game Boy. I think I had the charge pack, that's right.
New limited edition platinum Game Boy Advance.
Oh, man. See through for me, thanks.
I'm your bubblegum man. You know what I say to you. And you know what you gonna do. We gonna ride the bike.
I legit kind of miss that era of, like, translucent plastics. So you could see all the machinery inside. Yo, Fury, thank you for the reset for 3 months. Oh, actually.
You're great. Platinum Game Boy Advance.
I gotta let you know. I think you were really into Mario RPG back in the day, right? Have you ever played a mod, a ROM hack for it called Mario RPG Armageddon? Because it's actually pretty good. It's kind of wild. Anyways, back to video game. Yeah, I streamed it a few weeks back, but somebody hacked the game and basically turned it, like, they added 30 extra bosses and stuff. It's kind of wild. I could actually send you a ROM file on Discord. Yeah. Because I think you might enjoy it. This must have been right after the Kirby anime came out. Oh shit! I thought this was Smash Brothers for a second. This is really good. Minigames played at the corner of madness and mayhem, only on Nintendo GameCube. Rated everyone. Oh, this is Soul Calibur. Yep. Didn't even have to see the footage. Like, yeah, that's the Soul Calibur health bar. Oh boy, thanks for the raid, bud. We're looking at some old video game commercials / promo tapes / trade show footage. A lot of good stuff here. We're currently watching Link do some Hadoukens in Soul Calibur, aka the best version of Soul Calibur 2, the one with Link in it. Heihachi was alright. If you had Xbox, well, sorry about your spawn. Oh, was this Metroid commercial? Begins. I think this was a Metroid commercial. You can experience it. Yeah. Metroid Zero Mission. Her first adventure as an intergalactic bounty hunter. Rated E for everyone. Oh, man. You're a hedgehog, and you have supersonic power. This is Sonic Adventure 2. Sonic Adventure 2 Battle, I think, actually. Action. Yeah, this is from GameCube. And you're scared.
Focus. I want you to think about the marketing opportunities here. Okay, it's front of the paper. What part of supersonic speed do you not understand?
The right hedgehog is hard to find.
Oh man, what a good commercial.
With extra two-player action. Only on Nintendo Game.
Some of these commercials are legit. They're still really charming. Here is the true story. Of four friends picked a little. Yeah, like the real world Animal Crossing. I remember this one. Being themselves. And start being someone else. Animal
Crossing for Nintendo GameCube. A sheep moved into the village today.
Sweet.
Why am I always the one organizing the treasure hunts? Maybe I'd like to sit around blasting techno music all day.
that's legit exactly what you would do in the game. Every day, whether you're
playing or not. Trade you some wallpaper for your UFO.
You think I'm a chump? Try the raccoon.
That was the only interaction you could do with it. Just kind of move your arms in front. That was it. There was no dance emote.
X-ray vision. One of many superpowers you have in the game. Not in real life. Superman, Shadow of Apocalypse.
Oh man. You can maybe look at girls, but only if you buy Superman. At least it's not horny Donkey Kong. Oh man, Star Fox Adventures.
Ooka Toka Poo General Scales and Buddha.
I should try the N64 version of this, actually, Dinosaur Planet, because apparently that leaked recently. It doesn't run super great, as I understand, but probably worth checking out just for the historical value. I think this was like the last Final Fantasy game for a long time. Was this backyard football? This time we all get him! Yeah! Now you can play with NFL pros in your backyard. Only they'll be kids too. Yeah, it's gotta be backyard football. Now on Nintendo GameCube. Yeah, people were saying the new version of Crystal Chronicles had some problems. Sold separately, rated E for everyone. Also available on Nintendo Game Boy Advance. There is super I never got into it in as a kid, so I didn't have any nostalgia. Give it to me. Go. No. Hey, where are you going? Get back here. The right hedgehog is hard to find. Sonic, only on Nintendo GameCube. Two Sonics.
Chain jumps, war pipes, and more. There's lots to avoid in Mario Golf Postal Tour. Tony for Nintendo GameCube. Rated E for everyone.
Two Sonics. Maybe more. We're going to the Wii commercials now. Smooth moves. I remember when they first announced the title for the Wii, like, everybody was certain it was going to fail. And then it did, it was like the best-selling console for a very long time. We just do, okay? Apple Cinnamon Apple Jacks is part of this complete breakfast. You can't explain its great taste, so why try? Kellogg's Apple Jacks. We just get it.
know how to get the invincibility star? You will. Strategy maps on Mars.
Oh, okay. It's a tie-in for Applejacks.
Six Nintendo games.
I'm invincible. I'm invincible.
I can't hold any more cinnamon or sugar. But I knew they were wrong.
But can you see where the invincibility star is in Super Mario World?
Now there's even more cinnamon and sugar in Kellogg's cinnamon.
Yeah, a lot of people were mad that it wasn't going to be called The Revolution.
Only the world of Nintendo is such a blast, and the only way to get one of these free Nintendo posters is with two proofs from Kellogg's Cinnamon Mini Buns. Now you can show off the power.
It's not a bad poster. Oh, Mario Milk commercial! Hey, everybody in chat, pay attention. Because we're going to see footage of Mario drinking some milk real soon. Just want you to get ready for this. Rare footage of Mario drinking milk directly from the jug.
Wanna grow? The calcium in milk helps bones grow.
Okie dokie!
What is this, Paperboy 64? Yeah, it's gotta be Paperboy.
Warning. Such behavior
they brought back a lot of old franchises like Paperboy, Excitebike.
We recommend you try it at home.
Wave Race, actually, that came out on Game Boy originally. Entertainment system. Oh, it's just original Paperboy.
To master Kazumi Ninja, and to defeat the evil ninja Gyaku, you need razor-sharp reflexes.
Oh man, Kazumi Ninja.
And a really good cheat sheet with all the death moves.
Do you know all the death moves?
Yeah, Jaguar.
Oh, the Jaguar.
It's here, the revolutionary Neo Geo Pocket Color.
Wait, there were commercials for this?
With 16-bit power. Linkable to the Sega Dreamcast.
Oh man.
Revolving joystick.
I feel bad laughing at this because apparently it was legit a pretty good console.
Six cool styles. The graphics will blow you away.
Yeah, Jaguar had this whole thing where you were smart if you bought a Jaguar, except you really were not.
Science introduces the Joyride, the amazing new total body video experience that will help your child develop healthy habits that will last.
This looks like a nightmare. This looks awful. Hold on, I want to double speed this. Wait. We got to double speed this.
Healthy habits that will last a lifetime. The perfect family business.
With 16-bit power.
All right, hold up. I really hate the long YouTube video way of scrolling around. All right, let's get a good look at this here. Just playing some video games. Strengthens your legs, builds your arms. Oh man. I love gaming. I love gaming and playing video game.
It's great for kids of all ages. And
this is like the CrossFit of video games. If you like slightly move your ass left and right while you play video games, you become very strong.
The Joyride helps kids burn fat and calories, build hand-eye coordination, and work their muscles. And it's from Nordic Track, so you get the quality you expect.
So how much does this cost, do you think?
What a parent want in an exerciser. Oh, and it's the one they'll use because it's fun.
Joyride high technology turned ordinary video.
Yeah, I don't know what kind of game would use these kinds of joysticks. This would be awful to control. $300, $400.
Complete control for total intensity.
Tina saying $350.
Experience that's good for your body, and it's from Nordic Track because we care about kids as much as you do. Only Exerscience, the premier manufacturer of innovative home exercise.
Come on, tell me the price.
Bring you the amazing Joyride video.
You gotta tell me the price.
And get your kids on their way to a lifetime of good health. Order your Joyride, and for a limited time.
$400.
Plan. You make only four easy payments of just $99.99. The holidays are
here. Oh boy.
The best gift of all, the gift of health. Order your Joyride.
You could just buy a new console for that. You could buy a couple of consoles for that. Yeah, this was $1990, so like you could buy both consoles. You could buy a Nintendo and a Sega.
New Sonic the Hedgehog. Oh, he really ducked my doilies. They
say he's incredibly fast. Well, what's the hurry, mister?
Four easy payments of $99.99 make it seem Mario like you're spending less money.
Why can't it be more like that nice boy Mario? Little brat!
Now, get Sonic free.
Oh, the first Sonic, wow.
Sega Genesis system at its new price of $149.99.
When I play Terminator...
The $149, yeah, so you can buy a Genesis and a Super Nintendo.
The indestructible T-1000. Endless endoskeletons. The evil Skynet. Nothing.
Bobby! Come give your Aunt Bertha a big kiss.
Well... almost nothing.
No, it wasn't 60. It was you got a value of $60 because you got Sonic with it for free. Sound effects. Really? Night Trap?
How could you let that happen?
You're using Night Trap to sell the... Okay, well.
That wasn't too bad, kid.
I guess they really wanted to, show the FMV stuff.
Hey, do you really have to watch the rest of this stupid movie to see how it's gonna end? Here, take control with Sega CD.
Those aliens are masters of disguise.
Oh, man.
Not your typical video
game. FMV games are like a really special treat.
Better pay attention. Those aliens can look like anybody. Your brother, sister, anybody.
Hungry?
What's your name? No, it's Dog Meat.
Get this. At school, I found this magic lamp, and I wished for Disney's Aladdin from my Sega Genesis. It's like the movie. I got to battle sword-slashing thieves and nasty palace guards.
Now, this one I remember... was supposed to be the better version because it had, the sword. Super Nintendo version did not have the sword. Ground Zero Texas will kill the player in 10 seconds, starting if they don't figure out how to select a level. Big deal. I can die in 2 seconds if I play Home Alone 2 for the Super Nintendo.
If you were colorblind and had an IQ less than 12, then you wouldn't care which portable you had.
Oh, right. Here's where they were so very aggressive. You're stupid if you don't buy this console. Bright, beautiful color, as long as you were at a very specific angle and were willing to buy 6 AA batteries. That lasted maybe a few hours.
Game Gear.
Maybe insulting, but it's the truth.
You know what my friend here just called you? He called you a glass jaw.
Yeah, sorry, 12 minutes.
No jabbing wimp.
There was an adapter, but like...
Step into the ring, the Sega CD.
I feel like touting your big portable console and then having it require 6 AA batteries. Yeah, the screens were not very well designed.
Okay, takes back the bird neck part.
Oh man, Street Fighter. No sound effects are absolutely not in the game. Absolutely not in the game. You will not hear any of those sound effects.
Joe, what do you see?
Also, was that the Genesis version? I think that was the Genesis version of Street Fighter. Yeah, that was the Genesis version. The dog shit version, because it only had, what was it? If you had a 3-button controller, you had to press select to switch moves or something?
Some interesting things. Reggie White. Then we took that knowledge.
Or no, was it start? Because, yeah, by default, the controller only had 3 buttons. If you had a 6-button controller, it was probably okay. But, let's just say there's a reason fighting games don't really have concepts like that, where you have to swap your moveset by pressing a button. Their stance characters, that's about as far as it goes.
Welcome to Sega Channel.
Ooh, Sega Channel!
It's
cable, but you don't watch it, you play it. Your Genesis is hooked up to about 50 games a month, like Sonic and Knuckles, Earthworm Jim, and Super.
We know about these ones.
Get secret tips and test drive new games before they're out. Play what you want for as long as you want for one monthly fee. Sega Channel, stop just watching TV.
The Sega Channel, coming soon to Prime Cable.
Prime Cable.
It's Sega season at Prime Cable. Right now, Prime Cable came.
Oh, dog.
Pepsi,
cool dog.
Savings on the Sega Channel.
Thanks to this dog and also to Pepsi.
All you have to do is buy a cube of Pepsi at any area Kmart. And Pepsi are offering incredible savings on the Sega Channel, Sega Genesis units and games. All you have to do is buy a cube of Pepsi.
One cube of Pepsi, please. One cube of Pepsi, please. You have quite a treasure there in that cube of Pepsi. Oh shit. I get to meet Sonic and radio DJs? Ready to rumble.
From Midway.
Hey, Bobby!
Yeah?
How'd you like a chance to win everything
no.
Sega makes?
You mean a Genesis?
No, everything!
A
go away, Howie Mandel. Leave my home.
Yes! To win everything Sega makes, just go to McDonald's.
Yeah, I know it's like an actual term, it just sounds very weird to hear a cube of Pepsi.
Plus, five kids win a Genesis and Game Gear, and 1,000 others win a $5 book of McDonald's gift certificate.
Oh, baby. I love winning coupons because it means I have to spend more money.
Watch me trick flip. Coco Pebbles.
Oh, shit, is that the Riddler?
How'd you do that? Give me a Coco Pebbles and I'll show you.
Okay.
Tongue twisting chocolatey taste.
Bobby's world is very generic.
You're no cartoon.
Wanna bet?
Who's Coco Pebbles cereal? Part of this complete breakfast.
Sega has joined forces with
Marty's trick.
Now you can find a rebate offer good for $5 back on any of these Sega Game Gear games.
Hold up. Go back.
Dune Man, how'd you do?
Oh god. I really hate the long YouTube scroll bar. Alright, so VR Troopers, Jungle Strike, Super Return of the Jedi. Is that Eternal Champions? I have no idea what this is. And then Power Rangers the movie. So you have to buy one of these five games specifically.
Sega Game Gear game on Coco Pebbles or these other post cereals.
And if you buy one of those five games, then you can get $5 off.
Sean! Lunch!
Watch out, Sonic's coming! He's using a homing attack!
Food.
Sonic the Hedgehog pasta.
Food.
From Franco America.
Yo, whoa. Was there a pasta attachment for the Genesis? Hold up. I think the Sega Tower needs to be updated if there was in fact a pasta attachment. Sonic and Knuckles and pasta. I didn't have a Mega Pasta, no.
Fear has no form. Fear has no name.
That's, I've learned something today. Pasta and Knuckles.
Castlevania Symphony of the Night for your PlayStation from Konami.
Oh man, something in the night commercial.
Hiya, boys.
Hey, Pitbull Harry's on TV.
Well, look at Mr. Big Shot.
He looks good. Probably had a facelift.
This commercial's kind of cute.
Pickaxe.
He's got dames. Great. Harry's living in a 3D world with dames, and I'm stuck here with this freak running laps around.
It's all right,
the
Pac-Man, chair. He doesn't do anything these days, right?
Harry's got a box. I never had a box. I can't believe he's got a box.
It's all right, Pac-Man. You won't be you won't be relevant today.
Maybe. Who is it?
What time?
Well, it's big.
27-inch.
Yeah.
Picture in picture.
No, this was after Scream came out.
How do you know?
Under a white ceramic duck wearing a yellow raincoat.
Where are you?
Open the drapes.
TV Gex, no. Everybody already hates you.
Yeah.
tail time.
Cubic's Why do you have Robots to be a murderer now?
Is now a video game racing robots. Race around Bubble Town as your favorite Cubic's robot.
Pick up I'm aware they released the Pac-Man game yesterday. That was the joke I was going
video
for.
Game available for the PlayStation game console. Rated everyone.
Oh, this is the Grand Theft Auto 3 commercial.
If you do this for me, you'll be a made man. Anything you want.
God, looking back at this game, it doesn't look great. I know this was 2001, but man.
Grand Theft Auto 3, in stores now. Rated M for mature.
Yeah, we don't want to be Gex Pest over here. This isn't Wave Rate Blue Storm, this is a different game. Oh, just called Splashdown.
Oh, this is bad.
Who in jail? Yeah, GTA 1 and 2 were not very good.
Sly Cooper, he's one cunning, devious.
Oh, Sly Cooper! Rated E for everyone. Never played any of these games. I never played Sly Cooper. I never played Jack and Daxter. Goku! That's Goku! That's Goku too. That's another Goku.
Do, don't call them cartoons. They don't like being called cartoons.
That's right, it's Japanimation.
Available on PlayStation 2 rated T.
James Bond. Although, not the one that people remember, because it wasn't GoldenEye.
The first Bond game that feels like a Bond movie. 007. Everything or nothing.
Show of hands, who remembers this game? Nobody? Weird. Alright. So we've been watching that for about half an hour. Let's move on to the next video on our list, because I don't just want to watch commercials for the entire thing. We got some game tips. We got the Sega Dreamcast launch. Plenty more.
In other business news, Sega is rolling out a new video game.
Wait. I'm not done. Video game, we don't have Video Arcade Top 10, if that's what you're talking about.
Console this
I generally
week,
won't be showing like full episodes and stuff just because that could CNN potentially get you DMCA'd.
Rick Lockridge reports.
Yeah, this is a really high quality video.
In the cutthroat video game industry, one word seems to be all-powerful.
The graphics it's more realistic.
And embattled Sega's new Dreamcast video game console is graphically better. The first home unit able to handle 128
Look at that Sonic Adventure setup.
At once. Twice as much as the
bottom of the video. Oh yeah, you're right, sorry. One sec. That would explain why it's in widescreen, because it wasn't supposed to be in widescreen. There we go.
64 machines that dominate the $12 billion a year U.S. video game market.
60 frames a second, which is twice the speed of a TV. It equals graphics you've never seen.
I'm gonna get you to walk that statement back. That's not how it works at all.
Graphics you've never seen before. When you watch a football game,
I think he's trying to say like twice the speed of like a movie or traditional film broadcasts, but like
Dreamcast can draw.
That's not true at all.
Polygons a second, up to 15 times more than competing system.
If it was twice as fast as a TV, you wouldn't be able to see half of those frames.
Sega's errors as a company, though, have been well documented.
No errors in Sonic Adventure, by the way.
We've seen its market share plummet from more than 50% to about 1%. Can Dreamcast end Sega's nightmare?
They have a lot of.
Can Dreamcast end Sega's nightmare? No, it did not.
Game technology, and Sega's going to use this to make a comeback into the marketplace.
The $199 Dreamcast comes with a built-in modem, making it the first set built for online gaming. 18 games will be available right away. You can fight, fish, or skateboard. There's also a much-anticipated football game, NFL Y2K.
Yeah, Dreamcast was a perfectly nice system. It just didn't sell very well. Like the PS2 and, to a lesser extent, the GameCube kind of completely dominated it. I actually don't think the Dreamcast and the GameCube really shared much time.
The company hopes to sell a million units by Christmas.
Yeah, it did not.
CNN, Los Angeles.
All right. So this is the Howard Johnson Sega Game Gear tips. Let's start with Volume 1, just in case there's important plot information that we need to know. And I need to get the crop set up here and everything.
Good afternoon, sir. Welcome to Howard Johnson. Here, let me take those.
Yeah, thanks.
Right this way.
Did you know, sir, that Howard Johnson is the official hotel for Sega Video Game Fun?
So this is,
free Game Gear all summer long.
Yeah, yeah.
Apparently a promotion with the hotel chain Howard Johnson.
Hotels. Call hotel for details. And you know, sir, that
Howard and they had this guy screaming at you that you could play free Game Gears.
With Sega, it's the perfect family hotel experience.
Yeah.
Oh, you're a video game fan. Well, that's great, sir, because I know you're going to like it here at Howard Johnson.
I believe this guy also did the post-serial Sega tip video as well.
Oh, here we are, sir.
Here, let me get you a tip.
A tip? Did you say a tip?
Why is there so much flashing?
In Marvel
Comics,
why
is everything flashing so much?
Master Legacy. The blue pentagons against the walls are transporters. Use them or you'll never find your way out of the danger room. In Echo, the Tides of Time, use your sonar map to locate the three floating stars. Only these stars will open the wall for passage.
Yeah, I guess they were really hoping to capture, like, adults with income going for, like, oh, we need a hotel to stay with our kids, and oh shit, they give you free Game Gear.
Stand right beside the enemy and press buttons 1 and 2 simultaneously. It's a guaranteed offensive move that'll flatten the putty patrol.
Need that on my resume. 1994 did a guaranteed offensive move that flattened the putty patrol.
Aren't you the same? Welcome to Howard Johnson, sir, the official hotel for Sega Video Game Fun, where you can get free fun packs or a Sega game tip.
So I wanna point out here, real quick. The video is in fact skipping around. That's not me doing a bit. But I feel like it just kind of adds to like the weird fever dream of experience of shit just being blasted into your face. And like every time is jumping around again. That's not me doing a bit.
Video. Would you like to try a Game Gear while you're here, sir?
What?
A Game Gear, sir. The top selling full color
portable. This is like a nightmare you have when you eat too much cereal.
When free to use, join your stay here at Howard Johnson, where kids go Hojo.
Hojo.
Well, not just kids. I mean anybody, but mostly kids. Here, you give it a try.
No, thanks. Just a room.
Yes, sir. Here's your key.
It's like someone you used to work with.
This game, yes, sir. I
did
know
you work with them?
You can play all these great games from Sega. Here, take a look.
In Sonic's Robotnik Winter Zone, jump on the first icon you see to get the new jetboard. It's the fastest way to jump over enemies, zip through walls, and collect rings.
Wrong, actually, it's Sonic the Hedgehog.
Change the speeds and locations of your pitches in order to strike out the batter.
So, I had that game. I had that baseball game, it was not very good. That was a lie. You could change your speed and location of pitches all day. They would still hit it perfectly.
An evil cloud of darkness. As the temporary king, Mickey must rescue the Tree of Life or all is lost. Sorcery, dragon combat, and cowardly King Pete keep Mickey up to his mouse ears in magical adventure. Venture with Mickey across the bridges of destiny to five magical lands.
Michael Rodent.
Can I take your order, sir?
Wait, you're the same. Aren't you the same?
This nightmare man who will not stop plaguing me while I'm just trying to stay at the Hojo.
At least I don't think I'm the same guy.
The same as who?
The same as... Never mind. I just want to get something to eat.
No problem, look at you, insect. A pathetic creature, flesh and bone. Stumbling through my hotel hallways.
The Robotnik Reuben. Robotnik Sonic? What are you talking about?
Can I just get a bowl of soup?
No problem, sir. I recommend my favorite. The Game Gear Gumbo. Oh, and by the way, sir, did you know that Howard Johnson is the official hotel of Sega Video Game Fun? And
I know that.
Where you can get to play Game Gear for free. Whatever Game Gear is.
Like, this guy doesn't even want to play Game Gear.
Free fun packs for the little kids, right?
You forgot the video.
They already have his money. It's not like they need to sell him on the Game Gear.
Cool kids go Hojo!
Hojo! Sega Game Gear Game Kids. I have to do that.
That you could only find at Howard Johnson. Check this out.
It's like Max Headroom almost. 95.
An offensive air attack is essential to win. When throwing to a receiver, throw the ball as that receiver makes his cut.
That sound is not coming from the Game Gear at all.
In
awkward
X-Men,
silence, there
Genosha
we go.
Is ravaged by war and is teaming with the Unforgiven. Jump on top of the open columns to find hidden power-ups or use Rogue's flying powers to avoid assassination. In Echo the Tides of Time, all new 3D travel scenes transport you to the next dimension, but you'll have to find the four transporters or you'll swim forever in this land of interlude. In Fred Couples,
what if I just
want
to
first Sega Game
swim
Gear
forever.
Golf game in 3 years and it's a hole in one. Sega
Wait, hold on.
And the 1990s years and it's end of interlude. In Fred Couples Golf, the first Sega Game Gear golf game in 3 years and
Fred Couples Golf, excuse me. I think you mean 36 Great Holes starring Fred Couples. Anyways, we'll continue.
It's a hole in one. Sega Sports and the 1992
I just wanted to make sure that all the elements of real golf we were in fact aware of the fact that it was called 36 Great Holes starring Fred Couples.
PGA Tour Player of the Year, or you can play as Fred Couples and drive the ball 300 yards. Fred also provides an overview of
are any of the holes Fred's? Well, that's the secret 37th
four courses,
hole.
Four levels of difficulty, spectacular graphics, and realistic shot control make
if you do well enough.
Golfer's dream come true.
You see, on Sega Game Gear Game Tips video is the perfect answer to the "What'd you bring me, Daddy?" question. For just a few bucks or free, when you bring your kids,
I don't
want to
hear this guy saying "What'd you bring me, Daddy?" anymore
from
in my life.
From a Memorial Day weekend to Labor Day weekend, a child accompanied by an adult staying at Howard Johnson has a choice of a free fun pack or Sega Game Gear Game Tip video. But without a kid, you grown-ups have to pay for it.
Who is that guy?
Beats me. I thought it was with you. Anyway, time to watch this.
In Mighty Morphin Power Rangers.
The flashing only seems to happen when that dude is on the screen, which makes me think it's all occurring in this poor guy's mind.
Power up with Blue Ranger's special weapon to defeat King Sphinx. When King Sphinx is in a poised position, he cannot be
very similar to games
attack,
like Fight Club.
Press D-pad down, then right or left depending on
I
which
guess
way you're facing
books
and
videos like Fight
simultaneously.
Club.
In Sonic Triple Trouble, in the title planet zone, you must play as Tails to use the Sea Fox underwater. Go underwater at your first chance and go all the way down. Jump on
all
the purple plunger
the
to have an air bubble
down.
Lead you up to a ring icon, and then use your Sea Fox to break through the wall at the bottom of the sea to grab more rings. In Ristar, catch a rising star. Ristar, grab more rings.
So I'm going to point out here, they cut exactly as he got 69 rings. Literally one frame after he got 69, they cut. They knew what they were doing. They knew what was up.
Catch a rising star. Ristar, son of a legendary hero who's been captured, is the solar system's last hope against the evil space pirate Greedy. Ristar must travel from planet to planet.
This actually doesn't look too bad for the Game Gear, if this is on the Game Gear.
System, and finally, free his father. Use Ristar's long arms to grab, climb, and swing as he battles through 6 different planet levels and a cosmic bonus round. Discover new worlds and new creatures on each planet. Battle giant purple elephants. Climb through an ancient pirate ship.
Giant
and race
purple
the time
elephants.
Against countdown clocks. Become a
yeah, Ristar was a good game.
Walls, throw objects,
I never played the Game Gear version of it,
like
but
no other star has ever done before.
Looking at the footage, it looks pretty decent.
Sheesh, maybe if I take a swim, I can relax. Sonic Salads, Game Tipper, Robotniks. Sheesh,
Robotnik.
Yo, excuse me, sir. Like, are you on your way to the pool?
Yeah, I thought I.
Nightmare.
Going to the pool.
You're just like the others. I mean, you're.
Like, I'm the pool tenant, dude. Here for your.
Kid. Yeah, I'm kind of glad we started with part one here.
No thanks. I already have a towel.
So, like, how about this way cool Game Gear?
I don't want to play your Game Gear.
Some say this guy still is in the Howard Johnson building as we speak.
Just a little.
Yeah, I'm gonna be using the same controller for Honey 2.
Kids, dude.
Should actually check and make sure it's not, like, crystallized at this point.
What do my kids have to do with it?
Like, if your kids were here, dude, you get to play Game Gear for free, get free fun packs, or get a cool game tip video with game tips that rule. Check
my
it
kids
out.
Died in a car accident before you took me here. Hojo.
In World Series Baseball, use the hit and run. It's a good way to push runs across the plate.
What, like, hit the ball? Yes, that is generally a good way to score in the game of baseball.
Special healing powers. Energize your mutant powers while not in use to prepare for Shinobi Shaw. In Echo, floating water tubes are suspended in air. Swim carefully.
Shinobi Shaw.
Risk falling through the gravitational pull. Locate the flashing stars to morph into a seagull and fly to new heights.
And reminder, this is part one of two. There is, in fact, a second act to this. Of course. Why were old video game ads so horny?
Pillows, miss.
Oh, yes, sir, I will. You see, we promise you sleep tight, or it's a free night.
You get what's happening here?
Satisfaction guaranteed anywhere in the USA, Canada, or Mexico.
If something's not quite right, just let us know. If it's within our control, we'll make it right, or that night is free.
Well,
if you see our wait staff in a room doing their job, feel free to harass them. It really is just turning into like a psychological thriller.
Offense is moving the ball, then go for two.
The complete cut to some tips on football is what's killing me the most, I think.
Mighty Morphin Power Rangers, Megazord's power sword
Won't
be enough to defeat King Sphinx. Super transpose into Titanus to help knock King
Titanus.
Sphinx off his feet.
Titanus. I don't like when people pronounce it like that. Titanus.
Yes, and a ham sandwich, please. How long will that be? Right away. Thank you.
Titanus.
This summer at Howard Johnson Hotels, you'll take it easy. Your kids won't. You'll appreciate our comfortable rooms and courteous service. Your kids won't.
Your kids won't like it.
600 convenient locations.
Service.
So, like, they were trying to get people to book with Howard Johnson, right?
Did somebody say a Sega game?
Like, they wanted people to spend money on this company, right?
In Sonic Triple Trouble,
I feel like I probably would not want to book with this company.
You must outrun and outwit Metal Sonic and Knack the Weasel, and then hit the warm-up Dr. Robotnik 10 times. You can hit him on his sides or on top, but don't get underneath him or you're done for. Once you've hit him 10 times, it's time to move on to the final fight.
Oh, this was like himself. This is Game Gear, so this must have been mid 90s. I think that's when like Sonic Triple Trouble came out, like 94, attacks. 93.
In Mighty Morphin Power Rangers, use Red Ranger's special fighting techniques and power sword to defeat the evil Green Ranger. Once he's been defeated, the Green Ranger will then join in your...
I also love these tip videos that are just like, use all your moves and dodge attacks and you'll win.
Could you please send somebody up to get my luggage? I'm ready to check out now. Yes, thank you.
I'm ready to leave forever. Rare footage of somebody playing Sega Game Gear.
Right this way, sir. Sir!
Whoa! So, I almost wonder, they must have had adapters at the hotel, right? If they gave you unlimited Game Gear, because thinking about that, they would have gone through a lot of fucking batteries.
You're gonna be here with your kids when you get home, sir. Fun packs.
Like, there's no way they could have had everybody running Game Gears with batteries, right?
Sega stuff at Howard Johnson. They're sure
Hojo.
Glad you stayed here. Hey, maybe you can come back. Yeah, and bring your kids. Hey, they could stay free, you know. Kids go home.
Bring your kids. Bring your wife. We'll fuck her. That's right. We'll fuck your wife. Said Howard Johnson. You're fucked. Six ways from Sunday. Yeah, the glitchiness just, it got way worse at the end of the video when he started playing the Game Gear.
Thank you, sir.
Whoa. Hey, you forgot your tip.
Strange things may happen at Howard Johnson.
What?
While kids go Hojo with Sega.
Even what?
An unsuspecting, weary traveling father.
What?
Can get Sega-fied and become
this really is just Fight Club.
Here it is. One weary traveler looking for great family.
This is just Fight Club.
Business club where you can earn free airline trips and vacation and the official hotel.
It's Fight Club, except they advertise for a hotel chain that I don't. Are they still in business? Does Howard Johnson still exist?
At this Howard Johnson. Welcome to the next level. Sega!
Oh boy, 1995, there's your answer. Mid-90s. No Matrix yet. Oh, good lord. Yeah, I don't think I can watch the second video tonight if it's gonna be this shaky. We might have to do another night for that. For part two of the Hojo Sega Game Gear saga. Still exists? Oh boy. Alright. Let's see. So here is a game tape specifically for Ultra Games, which was just Konami under a different name because Nintendo had rules as to how many games you could release per year. This one's also like, this is 43 minutes, so we're not going to watch the entire thing. Just a little bit.
Welcome to the official Ultra Game Tape.
The official Ultra Game Tapes.
Great techniques for winning in Metal Gear.
Colonel.
To improve your scores in Skate or Die. And the path to victory in Defender of the Crown.
Yeah, this music is not exactly getting me pumped up to play some video games.
This game player strategy tape is full of hints.
Okay, hold the fuck on. You can't tell me this is how you're going to beat the video game and then, okay, I just want to make sure I'm not getting cut off. You can't tell me this is how you beat the video game and be like, oh, but you have to have played the game before. No. You need to tell me everything.
Tips and playing strategies. To get the most from this tape, we suggest you first read the manual that comes with the cartridge and also have some experience playing the game.
No.
Good luck. From the editors and game players at Game Players Magazine.
Play the game first. Good luck. No, it says play to win. Right?
Each Ninja Turtle has different talents. Once you understand their strengths and weaknesses, you'll know better how and when to use them. Michelangelo, for example, has a good striking range with his nunchucks, but isn't
no, he doesn't.
As his friends in other areas.
Michelangelo is like the second worst in the game, doesn't he?
Also limited in a different way. He's excellent at destroying small enemies as well as flying ones. He's the fastest ninja turtle, but he's weak against larger foes.
If I remember, like, Donatello was just straight out the best turtle, right?
He'll be the ninja to use in many areas, but for sheer turtle power, you should look elsewhere. Despite the fact that he's the slowest of the four, Donatello's raw strength and long reach make him...
Yeah, like, he was just flat out the best.
Plus, he's really deadly with his bow staff.
Bow staff.
Avoid these soldiers by climbing down the manhole.
Like, you only use the other characters as additional
most
health bars for Donatello.
It's a great place to use Raphael. Watch him perform some pest control here.
Okay. Hey guys, welcome to my Let's Play of Ninja Turtles.
You're about to meet Rocksteady. He's part gangster, part pig, and 100% trouble. Prepare for the fight by bringing in your toughest turtle, Donatello. As soon as you defeat Rocksteady, Bebop will take off with April. Follow them to the hideout.
I gotta... Actually, no, that wouldn't work. I was gonna say, they're not even gonna show the trick that used to beat him.
You don't need to climb down each manhole. You can go past the first one, but don't ignore the next. There's pizza down here, and you can get it again and again.
There's pizza down here.
Recharge your turtles this way. Rescue April by calling in Donatello against Bebop. Give
okay.
him a good thrashing with the bow staff.
So you wanna know the $1 million pro tip here? You pick Donatello like they're doing here. You pick Donatello like they're doing here, and you jump up to the top here, and then you just swing down, and you'll eventually kill him. He will never get up to hit you. Here's an actual tip. Here's something that you can actually use, doesn't require you to be good at the game, and you can go do it right now without having to have read the manual or anything. Just pick Donatello, stand up here, hold down, and just keep mashing B, and you'll eventually beat the boss. Real game tip. You're welcome. It's not a pure run. This is a play-to-win game tape.
Inside the dam, this enemy
not
is
a play
the
to have a pure run game tape.
From a life-replenishing pizza.
Life
ahead
pizza.
Is a risky jump. If you don't make it, you'll have to retrace your steps.
No. I'm gonna do it. I'm gonna do glitches and hacks.
You'll need two fully energized ninjas before beginning your underwater mission. The Foot Clan has planted bombs underneath the dam, and your job is to
this
find
damn mission was such
and disarm
a nightmare.
The explosives. Swim clear of the electric.
I used to be scared of the noise that the electric ivy, I guess, would make when he would touch it. I used to be scared of that would run out of the room when it went off.
Turtle soup.
Then I got older. No, this level was painfully difficult.
Attention to its patterns. You can swim out of the danger zone. Switch turtles if you need to. But make sure you have a lot of energy before swimming through these
undersea
planets.
Yeah, like when
planets.
He got zapped there, I'd be
rushing
running out of the room
really
as a kid.
Drains your energy. To disarm the last bomb, use the same techniques as before. Remember to watch the ocean current, the plant life, and the electrical currents.
Okay.
Welcome to the third stage. The
yeah, my cousin had that game, and I don't think we ever got past level 2. It was way too hard for all of us.
Blowing up roadblocks requires missiles, and here's where you get them.
Man.
Your energy levels
was such a weird game, thinking back on it.
So pizzas are more important than ever. Here's a full pizza.
Full pizza.
You don't have time to explore every building in New York, so let's look at the really important ones.
All right. We gotta look at the important ones. You know you can edit this video. There you go.
Don't waste your time in this room.
This game rescuing did not have save files, though.
Rescuing a capture turtle is not that difficult. You just need to know where to look for it. Follow us.
Yeah, you would have had to run this at the same time as your VCR or as your NES. I gotta say, this video isn't quite as charming as the Skip Rogers video the last time.
You've performed your good deed for the day, and now it's time to make tracks to the end of level 3.
While
you're moving, seek and destroy all enemy tanks. Your best move is to save your missiles by using bullets, but you don't want to waste ammo either.
There's nobody in, like, really, really ostentatious jackets in this one. It makes me kind of sad. God, look at all that flickering. So I guess this is why the video is 40 minutes long, because they show you absolutely everything, which probably would have been a good thing as a kid, but man. Man.
Trail behind this missile and let it clear a path.
This is like a full unedited minute of no commentary going on there. It doesn't even really have screen wipes, it's just like fades and cuts. It definitely doesn't have the TurboGrafx walking into frame transition, which I think is the best one I've ever seen. No, we're not watching a long play. I think this is just,
here's your final destination for this level.
It probably goes through almost the entire game, it looks like. Actually, yeah, it's pretty much the entire game.
And your odds are good. There's only one of him, but four of you.
Yeah, this one doesn't seem quite as entertaining. I was hoping there'd be some very, very funny quips, but there were not. This is just strictly information, informative. Let's move on to the next one. We got more.
In all the world of toys and games, there's only one name that holds unprecedented power. Nintendo. For as millions of kids know, when you're playing
with
Nintendo,
Gray Zapper,
you're playing with power. And as retailers across the country know, that means power.
So this is a tape specifically for retailers.
In just 4 short years, we've witnessed
the... So there's going to be a lot of graphs here, but...
And Nintendo's the leader of the packs. We now command a 75%...
Oh god, the power pad.
And the momentum keeps building.
We now command everything.
A world of profit in the name Nintendo. And a world of opportunity waiting for the retailers who take advantage of the built-in sales appeal of the Nintendo line. That's why for 1989, we've created a merchandising program that's out of this world. A program that combines the power of the visual cell with the draw of the Nintendo name.
Tell me how it's
Welcome
out of this world.
To the world of Nintendo. More than hardware, software, and accessories, the world of Nintendo is a central collection of Nintendo branded and licensed merchandise.
Oh, wow.
Everything our target audience wants. And
this is like the Nintendo World Store before the Nintendo World Store existed.
The world
Wait,
of Nintendo is
are we just gonna convenient place. We're just gonna ignore the mannequin? Just gonna ignore the mannequin sitting back there? We're just gonna ignore the mannequin.
The world of Nintendo is a magical environment. A place that attracts and captivates customers.
It's magical.
Entertains them with a great selection of their favorite games.
As long as you pay us, as long as you buy our products.
And all of this helps salespeople serve customers better and faster. The world of Nintendo is a place that will turn product into profit faster than ever before. There are
we will efficiently take your money.
Backpacks, t-shirts, and other ready-to-wear.
Oh my god, Super Mario Brothers suspenders.
Linens, sleepwear, and...
I'm secretly kind of scared that they're going to show the door hanger that I have. The Bowser door hanger, and I'm just going to immediately crumble into dust.
Sleeping bags. Plush toy.
Well, gonna take a moment to enjoy these chufty Mario and Green Marios.
Hats and much, much more. All bearing the name that turns on sales.
What's more, turns on sales.
Nintendo is busy boosting incremental sales and profits on your Nintendo merchandise. It's also pulling people to and through your store, buying all the way. To create this world of opportunity, Nintendo
tell me about
offers
the
best in merchandising materials and support.
Yeah, some bees got into this tape.
Line of eye-catching point of sale
This is like the Akewood comic where they make the pancakes for Philippe. This is like firmly in the neighborhood of, hey, Philippe, these not so bad, we, the Mickey Mouse pancakes. We're like, it's clearly not correct, but it's close enough.
Plays and materials.
Like, you could tell at a glance that that's Link, even if it's not Link.
And exciting interactive demos to counter cards, logo signage, store fixtures, and video displays. Everything you
yeah, our store had all the Nintendo games locked behind glass cases, so we had none of these.
It's a look that generates excitement and stimulates sales.
No video games sitting out in the open for me, thanks. We would like to not lose all of our sales and have them stolen.
We offer a generous merchandising allowance. Set up a World of Nintendo profit center, and we'll give you double the accrual rate.
20 cents for a game? Oh, why didn't I just buy it directly from Nintendo? Damn, I got ripped off.
We'll even let you roll over any unused portion of last year's 1988 merchandising accrual so it can work for you in 1989.
Ooh.
It's all part of our plan to help you set up a supercharged store environment that will power up sales. But that's not all.
Like, it would be pretty cool to have some of this old merchandise, but
Merchandising Incorporated. This Nintendo
I do wonder how much, like, they stated you could and couldn't have.
Merchandising professionals who make it big.
I really love that the buzzing showed up when this guy came back on screen.
Merchandising professionals who make it their business to know how the world of Nintendo can work for your business.
Like, no buzzing for that guy, just this guy in the pink shirt.
Five merchandising professionals who make
like, really, look.
Merchandising Incorporated. This Nintendo subsidiary is a team of over 100.
Like, the second this part starts up. And in case you're thinking, oh, well, no, it was buzzing there before, look carefully. Look in the background, there he is. There's the man.
Merchandising professionals who make it their business to know how the world of Nintendo can work for your business.
He's trying to escape, because he knows the Sega guy is going to be coming for him. He's going to be staying at the Hojo.
The information they gather is analyzed and used in planning the best product mix for your store. And in developing merchandising strategies
Bees
and
the
displays
tape.
That really move product. They help you create your own world of Nintendo selling space and work with your people to educate them on new products and promotions. Then, they get down to basics.
Like, I kind of want one of these old displays. Even though it would take up so much space.
Restocking shelves, replacing damaged packaging, adding new POP materials, anything that can be done to enhance sell-through and turn your Nintendo space into a place of fast-paced profit. So get ready to enter the world.
That's actually
Nintendo
not an effect on the video. On that's just how he sounds in real life.
Because the door to opportunity in 1989 has our name on Nintendo.
That's just how he talks. He's got a condition. You gotta be nice to him.
Markham likes to.
All right. This is a report on violence in video games. This must have been the late 90s, because I think they talk about Redneck Rampage.
Entertainment in Santa Monica, California, and is one of the 10,000 estimated game designers in the industry. His specialty? A game called Redneck Rampage, and it's not for the squeamish. It features violence, blood, and various insidious weaponry, and he makes no apologies for it.
The whole fascination with violence in video games is nothing more than an adjunct to what's going on in
nah, Pokemon is violent forever. As
mean,
hell.
You know, look back to, you know, Greek plays, you've got guys gouging their eyes out on stage and doing all sorts of wild stuff. It's just, that's pervasive in human behavior, so it's going to manifest itself in everything, including
this games. Was Build Engine, right?
Markham says he believes there is too much debate about the violence, and that the real star is the animation and effects. That is what he says fuels this industry.
This is
yeah,
a
look at that
like
back hair.
You know, you've got graphics technology from the hardware manufacturers getting better, so certain developers are going to always
gotta really, that really get a good look at that back hair. Obliged to keep up with that. It was a build engine game, yeah. I don't know. Oh, probably because it doesn't like the word redneck.
Technological wizardry comes new ways to make the experience more graphic and more immersive, from the rendering of the 3D environments to the motion capture of real actors.
Here, I get to play anything from the tiniest.
I love old motion capture rigs, all the weird tubes.
Biggest, most burly security guard.
Some experts warn this immersive, almost lifelike experience desensitizes people in a troubling way.
You're engaged now as the aggressor. You're engaged as the person.
How many times has that argument been made, I wonder?
Someone who watches the violence.
The designers at Zatrix claim this is no different than when they were kids. It's just that the environment has changed.
When I played in my physical space...
Like, people used to think old, shitty video games with, like, really crude representations of blood.
I was acting out the same aggressive behavior that all kids do act out. I was just doing it in a physical space.
Yeah, Redneck Rampage is lifelike. Look at that. Look at all those triangles.
We tried to make our violence a little more...
I don't have that many triangles in real life.
I was a big Warner Brothers cartoon fan when I grew up. I think Chuck Jones is, like, incredibly brilliant. But his stuff was very violent, but in a... whimsical kind of a way, I think.
I think Automod is just really big on the term Redneck Rampage for some reason.
The message or make it any less appealing. In fact, some experts say it has just the opposite effect.
There's a good deal of evidence.
God, that's a really slow machine they're running Redneck Rampage on.
Real life film, because animation gets rid of all the extraneous variables.
Everybody ready?
These designers are brainstorming. They're focused.
It's actually kind of funny that they're stop.
Bigger technology, bigger.
I was about to say, it's funny that they're focusing on Redneck Rampage and not Duke Nukem, which, like, it has the violence, and also women take their tops off. Also, this dude with the bare feet on the table, fucking gross.
Bigger technology, bigger weapons, and bigger laughs.
That guy is the gross guy. Don't be that guy, please.
You know, on the head every time she looks at you. Yeah, big bloody rolling pin, yeah.
Somewhere
get your gross feet off the table. Get
all of this.
Life is twisted. Just two good old boys trying to get the take back who's been abducted by aliens. I mean, how serious can you take that?
Designer Drew Markham says to him,
cheater, you use the
part of the fantasy, it's the underlying theme.
It's kind of fun to do stuff that you can only fantasize.
I'm reminded of that video about Richard Stallman, like, picking skin off of his feet and eating it in, like, some kind of Linux conference or something like that. Ugh. Ugh.
What I think they should be doing, but I'm not going to really do that. In a game, we can take out that aggression, and it's a good outlet for it.
Still, there are those who caution that it isn't all a joke. Many experts feel that violent games will inevitably lead to violent behavior.
These video games give people...
I wonder if this was before or after Columbine.
Easy, it's comfortable, it's encouraged, there's no other option.
Because they're not talking about Columbine at all, so I don't think it happened yet.
Not just for critics, but for many game makers themselves, who claim it's an issue of bandwidth, not brainwashing, and say they're hoping to have the technology soon to go beyond violence as the dominant character trait.
When we build a game like this, typically all we
Why would I bring that up? Because the one dude with his bare feet on the table was gross as hell.
Point where we're going to have the bandwidth.
At least get a coaster or something, God.
And we'd like to introduce this idea of social interaction so that there's a bit of a sense of right and wrong in the game. It's not just kill everything you see.
But beyond the promises, these designers know what sells.
Well,
and for now, most
No, Redneck Rampage is going to kill everything you see.
Affect the bottom line.
Am I pandering? No. But if I want to sell a product, I've got to have a certain amount of, you know, violence and aggressive, you know, outlet in there for the person who's paying their $50 to pick this thing up and play it.
And with game development costs pushing $2 million and development timelines...
Oh, baby, early internet.
It seems
unlikely. Give more footage of that.
Game designers will forego the one trait that so far has proven all but essential to success. Up next, something new in computer games, a special effect that adds more realism to the game. See it in action when we come back.
What's the effect? Oh no, we're not going to know. That's the end of the... Why would you stop there? Why would you stop right before learning about the special effect? Jeez. All right. This one is about Nintendo Wizards, Young Adults, and Yuppies. This one is around 1990.
Nintendo players say it takes skill, it takes hand-eye coordination, it takes quick reflexes, and there are Nintendo competitions, Olympics, nationwide competitions.
Nintendo Olympics.
Home sales, home video sales are now $5 billion a year.
$5?
Nintendo owns 80% of that market. Who plays Nintendo, you may ask? Well,
yeah, there's a little bit of buzz in this video.
Nintendo players are between ages 6 and 15, and most of them are boys. Welcome to the Petkoff home in West Los Angeles. 12-year-old David has his 12-year-old friends, Tony.
That's the guy from The Wizard.
In his room to play Nintendo. Oh, yes.
Oh, I think this one has a. Yeah, the dude puts his watermark all over the video.
The obsession? Super Mario Brothers 3, the hottest Nintendo game around.
I'm sure that won't be obnoxious. What is this music?
Who's more famous?
Why would they pick that music?
Super Mario.
Mario.
Look out, Walt Disney. So what's the attraction?
Like adventures, you gotta beat people.
Nintendo yeah. Wizard. This kid is so credited like, as a Nintendo Wizard. Put that on your resume, kid.
You feel that you're in the game for me. It's fun.
And what's it take to be a great Nintendo player?
Practice. You just gotta play a lot.
Nintendo and Wizard.
What's this? Books? That's right. Nintendo players buy books and call Nintendo hotlines to get advice.
That's just the game manual. That's the game manual that comes with the game.
You feel you have to, you know, finish it. So you just keep going.
Yeah, you can't get rid of the game until you finish it.
He's got this kid at our school named Jude. He's a Nintendo freak, I'm serious. He's got Nintendo pins and he's got the
This Jude kid, man.
He's got the watch.
He's got the teeth, you know.
The watches you can play.
Wait, he's got the teeth? And he got teeth? Jude got teeth?
No freak, I'm serious. He's got Nintendo pins, and he's got the magazines, and...
He got the watch.
He's got the teeth, you know, the watches.
Did Nintendo... Were there Nintendo teeth that I weren't aware of? Was there a peripheral for your teeth?
And get this. Kids routinely play 2, 3, 4 hours of Nintendo a day.
Yeah, who would do that? Play multiple hours of video games in a day?
Yeah. Because I don't do my homework sometimes.
And because of that, parents are urged to keep Nintendo use in moderation.
This isn't going
to
be obnoxious at all. Like, I don't care if you have a watermark on your video, but like,
do I play it?
I need to show the one video.
Sure, and I always win.
Of the most obnoxious pre-intro I've ever seen in my life. Remember,
the fastest growing group of Nintendo players, young adults. This is my first game ever. I was humbled quickly by young Michael, but look at my eyes, glued to the screen. No blinking.
Oh, I see. When the player
look at my eyes. Look at my soul. It is gone.
All right.
I wish to go to the Hojo.
Why do you think kids are the best Nintendo players?
Because
they're young.
They're young. Their fingers move fast.
I mean, tell that to Daigo.
Tomorrow, yuppies.
Kids were very much not good at video games because they hadn't played them that much.
Right now, at the beginning of this year, one out of every five homes.
Like most things in life, how good you are at something is usually a function of how much time you spend doing it.
That's how fast it's growing.
How long did it take you to get blinking again after that?
I don't know. You look at yourself, you realize you're a zombie staring into that screen playing.
It's scary. Like
if I were to fight a kid in Guilty, what?
Oh, Mario! Whoa.
Come on, playing.
It's scary stuff. All right, thanks, Todd.
Yeah. Bring Todd
down a hole. Hold on.
All right, thanks, Todd. Yeah.
Bring
We're
Todd down a hole. There he's jumping around with yourself. You realize you're a zombie staring into that screen playing.
Hang on a second. Did they just like shift to a different plane of existence? Did we enter the Diddy Kong's Quest dimension here?
Good stuff. All right, thanks.
Your shirt is blue now.
Jumping around with his Nintendo. Oh, Mario. Whoa.
Come on, Mario.
This video just goes to a different dimension.
You really want to be good. That's why most Nintendo players are boys, age 6 to 15. But the fastest.
Wait, does it just loop twice?
Nintendo players are young adults, age 18 to 44.
Oh, no. No, no.
35% of all Nintendo
players are 18 to 44. Yeah, this guy loves the Mets.
And that's where we begin our story today.
Hi, I'm John Bruno, and I'm a Nintendo addict.
Hi, I'm Derek Broussard, and I am truly an Nintendo
addict. Hi, I'm youtube.com/GrooveRaider.
Hi, I'm Frank Wicks, and I'm a Nintendo addict.
Hi, I'm Cindy Wicks, I'm a Nintendo widow.
What? What?
Now granted, Nintendo home video games are primarily...
You want to explain that at all? Nintendo killed my husband? What happened?
The so-called yuppie crowd, you know, 25 to 40 years old.
Was Mario her husband?
Competitions like this one, in bars, with prize money.
I think it's,
did the dimensional shift kill her husband?
You definitely can spend a lot of money at this. There's a new game...
Ooh-wee! There's a lot of stuff to pack out of this video, man.
I can't stop
the graphics, the advanced technology, the sound Pepsi. Effects, greater playing capacity is fueling the growth of Nintendo. And people like Magic Johnson are lending their names to video games.
Wham!
It's everything as far as basketball and more.
And now you can take Nintendo wherever you want to go with the Nintendo Game Boy, pocket size, with interchangeable cartridges. More than 5 million will be sold by the end of this year.
A lot of my friends, they think they're good, and I think I'm good, and we just sit back for hours. And
Atari, I think it did get news reports, just not quite as much. Go at it? Or if there were, they weren't really recorded.
2 hours a day. So 4 days or 8 hours.
This guy's name is two first names.
Are you married? No, I'm married to the Nintendo. Well, we've been together about a year.
I'm married to the Nintendo. Don't worry, buddy. In like 20 more years, people will be married to their virtual wives.
And if Nintendo divorces you, you don't have to pay alimony.
No,
so
that's the best thing about it. Just throw it out in the garbage when you're done, you know? My buddy, you have a little tournament at home and...
God, this video is killing me. If you divorce your Nintendo, you just throw it in the garbage. Nintendo killed my husband and divorced my wife.
Before I know it, it's like 12 or 1 o'clock, and I
haven't... Nintendo put a watermark on this video.
This is usually what I think I play, but she would prefer less than that.
Your husband Frank says he plays about 5 or 6 hours a week of Nintendo. Is that true?
No, it's more like 5 or 6 hours at a time.
What's it like being...
Oh, here we go, the Nintendo widow.
A lot of listening to... The music is the most annoying thing, I think.
It subtracts probably from our marriage. It subtracts time from us, but it keeps me happy.
My wife hates it, but I like it, so fuck her, I guess.
At least I'm not with another woman. Until they come out with a Nintendo affair, I don't know.
What? We're all these gross people!
Merchandise might be doing something else. Subtracts.
Yeah, at least I'm not cheating on her.
But it keeps me happier when I... Might be doing something else, I guess. At least I'm not with another woman.
What the fuck?
Nintendo affair, I don't know.
I mean, it's your choice, babe. Either I get to play a Nintendo or I fuck someone else. You know, it's not a hard choice to make, I think. you crazy Nintendo husbands.
Game cards here. This one a guy sent me. It's a thumb master, and it's a rubber tip, and you put your thumb in the thumb master.
That was spectacular, NC. Thank you for the resub. Also, I apologize in advance.
You're great. 3 hours late to inform you the team subbed for 3 months and nice.
We have transported immediately into the Bubsy dimension, but that's okay. This is a little bit into the video. I had to kind of scan and make sure that there was some good stuff here. Sorry, there's something much better at the beginning. Don't worry. So we're going to go back to the start of this video because there's much better games there. So like I said, better games are going to be in this one. Such as Virtual Bart for the Super Nintendo. God. This might be the only recorded footage in existence of Virtual Bart at Summer CES. So like, you're literally witnessing history in the making here. I hope you all realize this. I kind of want to see if there's footage of, there's balls. Another great game, another classic of game. I'm trying to see if there's, like, footage of the... Oh, here we go, Wario apparition. Time to get sucked off, people. Look alive.
Yes, talk to me. Hello, you rotten person. How are you today? Are you rotten?
So this is after Donkey Kong was cancelled.
So what can I do to make your day a lot worse, anyway? I make it rain inside the building here. Wouldn't that be rotten? Oh, I wouldn't be dead. So what is your name?
They had to explicitly tell Charles Martinet, please stop being horny.
Where are you from, Larry? Indianapolis. Oh, I hate Indianapolis. Only place I hate more than Indianapolis? Chicago.
Yeah, fuck you, Chicago.
Hey, how about this weather, huh? Beautiful morning this morning, all drizzly and rainy.
Gives a really good view of Wario's chin.
Dying dead on the ground. But it wasn't hot. On the bright side, stop looking on the bright side, will you? Right out loud, I'm trying to have a cranky day. Look it, look it. Wario on a stick, isn't that charming? Oh.
So Larry, you can tell Charles Martinet was having a lot of fun here.
Didn't your mama teach you any better than that? No, I guess not. You like it here in Chicago?
I kind of like this version of Wario just, like, casually taking you apart.
What do you do for a living, Larry? You sell a lot of what? Automotives? Well, what the heck are you doing over in this part of the building? Get out of here. Security!
Like not explicitly screaming about, you know, getting money and all that stuff, but instead just really, really roasting you. Yeah, yeah, we watched the Donkey Kong video. I think that was actually one of your uploads, right, Toti? I think you uploaded that one.
It's a rotten game. Everybody likes it.
Yeah, Donkey Kong got very horny.
Mamma mia, you look up ugly in the dictionary, you see your face. What the
heck are
you anyway, a bug? Ooh, a little fly. Look, everyone, it's a gnat. Yes, yo?
Jesus Christ, Wario, calm down.
A bug? The controller. Ooh. You evil controller.
Yeah, like, just imagine you had a really bad day. Maybe you were demoing something at this convention. Didn't go so hot, so you come around to check out the other stuff. You walk up to the Wario booth, and then he just destroys you.
Oh, from the metropolitan area north of Virginia.
Aww. Oh, wait a minute, hold up. That's Betamac. That's the actual Little Mac and not the weird blonde guy. See, look, he's got the dark hair. For some reason, they replaced him in the final version. Charles Martinet now owns a Donkey Kong video. Hell yeah. I hope he has it on. He just like has it handy at all times to remember where he came from. It's interesting to watch the old versions of these. Sometimes, like, the beta versions are way different. Gabby J, still Gabby J, though. Jabby Gay! Well, that was a different noise. That was a different... Yeah. It's actually one of Charles Martinet's first voice acting gigs for a video game here, Super Punch-Out. He did pretty much all the voices, I think. Yeah, I wonder if they had, like, a different voice sample and just decided, nah, we'll just use Charles Martinet, he's here. Yeah. I think that might still be him, though. I mean, the music sounds the same as the final version, from what I can tell. Yeah, I wonder why they changed that voice. Oh, don't get beaten by Gabby J, dude. Please don't get beaten by Gabby. Oh, you're getting beaten by Gabby J! Come on. cannot get beaten by Gabby J. How much longer does he play? Oh god, he plays this for a while. Let's jump forward a little bit. See if Bear Hugger is any different. He doesn't really have a lot of voice clips, actually, Bear Hugger. He just kind of goes, ooh, when you knock him down. Yeah, okay, let's move on. Let's see if there is any, stuff that isn't just them watching the game. Street Fighter. Oh, this doesn't look great. The things don't connect properly. Is that Saturday Night's Flame Masters? Come on, give me footage of walking around the floor. I think it's just most of them playing video games. Oh, Skyblazer. No, that's not Skyblazer. I'm trying to see if there's, like, any stuff of them walking around the floor, seeing any more stuff like Charles Martinet being horny. A little combat. Maybe we'll see Guile again. We saw Guile in the Donkey Kong video. So, like, you think this guy is, the shirtless dude, is there for, like, the booth? Like, you think he's there to show off the game, or you think he just wandered in and just wants to play Mortal Kombat? Yeah, I think most of this video is just them, oh, there's Vortex. Most of them just looking at footage of games or playing games, which is fine, but basically a face cam, a video camcorder LP at this point. Yeah, only like 1% of this video is Charles Martinet being an asshole at people. Oh, man. Alright. Well, it's about time to call it for the night anyway, so we'll do that. And part 2 of the Howard Johnson Game Gear Tips video, which we'll give a little teaser of. Part 2 of the Waking Nightmare, that is the Howard Johnson Game Gear Tips video, will be probably next time that I do this, once I get some more videos to watch. Is this actually just the same video, but with slightly different tips? Oh, I think this is just the same video, but the tips are different. Aw, man. I guess I was probably hoping too much for them to do a separate video in part 2. It's just the same thing with different tips. Damn. That's a good frame to end on. Alright, well, thank you everybody for coming out and enjoying some retro game tape / promo video / show footage. It's always a fun time. I will be back on Sunday because 100% is happening this Sunday at 2 p.m. Eastern. Which, 100%, if you're not familiar, is I'm going to be playing through a Mario RPG randomizer seed with the controller dipped in honey. This isn't a goof. I'm not saying, I'm going to dip my controller in honey and then it's going to be like a JPEG of honey. No, I'm actually going to put my controller in a bowl of honey and play through a Mario RPG randomizer seed. So, definitely show up on Sunday, 2 p.m. Eastern. That's when it's happening. If not, I'll definitely be archiving the VOD. God, VOD, how old am I? VOD. And, yeah, definitely show up there. It's probably going to be a good time, and then likely won't be streaming the Monday afterwards, because I'll A, have to recover, B, clean out all the honey and stuff. And I will need time to recover emotionally from the honey. So, have a good one. I will see you then, and I'm going to host you over to Emily, PA Master. She is doing some Monster Hunter Rise. She's on high rank, so if you don't want to see the high rank stuff, I guess, you might not want to see that if you want to remain completely unspoiled. But hey, if you do, I know a streamer you can go watch right now. Take it easy. Have a good one.